Is that it up there? Is this it?
I don't know, man. We're just gonna have to find out.
Whoa.
Holy shit, dude.
But that's a podcast.
But that dude.
Trash. Do you wear pants in the swimming pool?
Why?
Jersey Shore was the shit, dude. Fuck you.
I just saw the curtains move.
I ain't scared of no ghosts.
This is for Scoot Scoots.
Dude, there's a ghost.
Yeah.
There's white jihadists.
Shit on my chest. It'll make me hard.
What if I'm, like, pooping and then...
The anal stimulation.
Is that, like, a poop spoon?
You were like, the podcast needs this.
Yeah.
100% convinced that that's shit. It smells like it.
My tits are dripping.
Wait, why?
Burger.
But you smelled your finger.
There was no questionable, like, oh, this might be bad. And then I shit myself. It was like, I just suddenly have shit my ass.
And I say, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey.
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 Hi, Wes.
Hello.
Hi, Honesty.
Hello.
Hello.
My beautiful wife. My beautiful best friend.
Oh.
You guys know where we're at right now?
I know that I'm beautiful.
Well, I guess that's all that matters, huh?
Nobody's ever told me I'm beautiful before.
Really? That's a lie.
My wife might,
I've told you that you're beautiful before.
She might have said that at some point.
Are you talking about people other than me? Because I'm like, I'm sure that I have called you beautiful before.
Okay.
At least once.
Well, see, you just don't let me have things.
No.
Yeah.
No.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. You don't let me have things.
No.
Yeah. You don't let me have anything.
Nope.
Okay.
I don't.
You're a good best friend.
I know.
But where are we?
We're in the basement.
This is the most above ground basement I've ever seen.
And you know what's above us?
Do I need to say it?
I mean, you don't have to. I guess I'll say it.
I think it's the laundry room.
No, Amelia's room is above us.
Is the basement above us?
No, we're in the basement.
Oh. Sorry. There's no bad answers.
Yes, there is. There's actually a right answer to this.
No, I mean, we're an accepting and open space here.
There's
no wrong answers.
Yes, there is.
No, there's no wrong answers.
Welcome to Blue Skies from the Basement. My name is Austin.
No, what's above us?
Joining me, as always, is my best friend, the Savage Dad himself, Wes.
I can't believe you're not going to tell me.
I tear it up a little. I just said, what's above us?
Well, you said Blue Skies from the Basement, but that's a podcast.
Blue Skies is above us.
Oh, okay. No, I get it.
Because we're in the basement.
Yeah, no. Wow.
But it's dark outside.
Oh, my fucking God.
No, good point. I hadn't thought of that yet. You guys ever see the... Austin's not in a great mood, and we're already pushing every button that we can possibly find. You guys ever see 10 Cloverfield Lane?
No.
No.
It's with John Goodman, and he's got, like, a bunker, and it's, like, the end of the world. Like, quote-unquote, you're not really sure, like, the world's actually ended, and he hasn't just, like, kidnapped this chick who got in a car accident and took her down to his bunker. So she keeps trying to break out because she's, like, paranoid and doesn't believe it. And then, obviously, it's a Cloverfield movie, so, like, duh, the end of the world happened. But it would be really funny if that whole time, like, it was a bunker, but, like, you could see, like, it was above ground, and, like, it was just, like, this. Like, if the bunker was just this space right here, and that was the whole movie, it'd be a lot funnier.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Joining us again is my wife over there. Honesty, she's off camera, so you guys can't see her if you're watching on YouTube.
I ruined your intro.
Hey.
You ruined my night already, so there's that. That's just basically where we're at. So.
Cheers.
Yeah, fucking cheers to that, dude. I drank, like, half of my beer while you were sitting there talking. I was like, I'm going to need this.
I should start an OnlyFans, but it'll just be, like, me on the podcast. Like, you have to pay to, like, see me be on the podcast.
That's actually really fucking smart.
Yeah, that's a genius idea that
we
should
do
actually
do. We could do a whole separate feed of just you, and then we can just throw the audio into it.
Hmm. Yeah.
Hmm.
Make that money. Yeah.
When I'm just sitting here in my little blue star pajama pants that your mom got me for Christmas, like, 3 years ago.
Oh, yeah? You just made some dude hard out there.
That's what I was going to say. It's like you should describe yourself since they can't see you.
Yeah. What's that shirt you're wearing?
It's from Toy Story.
Who's on it?
Is his name just Rex?
Rex.
I know who it is. And I can't see the bottom of your shirt when you were like showing it either because like...
I mean... It's a pretty iconic top half of the head, though. You should be able to figure it out from the top half.
No, I know, but she was, like, pulling it down like I was, like, able to see the whole thing.
What information were you missing to be able
I
to
wasn't
say...
missing anything. Okay. That's why I said I know who the character is.
Like
I wanted her to answer it.
Okay.
She is describing herself. That's why I asked her.
Oh, good point.
Anyway, it says...
We ruined the OnlyFans already.
It says, rawr.
It does say rawr. It's a cool shirt.
Thanks. It's my sister's, but yeah. It's mine now. She doesn't listen to the podcast, I don't think.
Oh, that's fine. Do you want to just do the podcast now since we've checked him out entirely?
Yeah.
Cool. So I know we talked about our weeks already, but...
We did.
Yeah. Well, what else is going on? While he chucks the rest of it.
Okay.
Hey, buddy.
To get into this shit.
Hey, what's up?
So, remember how we shouted out Clara?
Yeah.
This week? Well, she sent me an Instagram DM. Okay? So, I'm going to read you that DM right now.
All right.
She said, LOL, I appreciate the shout out. Great podcast, very funny. And to answer your questions, number one, I am out all night every night because my parents are almost always away on business trips, so I have no supervision.
That's...
Depressing?
I mean, depressing, and also, I kind of guessed that, like,
yeah.
Given the... The list of things that I've already heard that happened to her, I'm like, well, she just doesn't have anybody watching her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel it. Like, my parents were gone a shit ton when I was younger, like, either, like, pool league or, like, they were in a bowling league, I think, at one point, and then just, like, just always being out. So, like, half the time I was at home by myself anyways. So,
yeah.
I'd just go out knowing that they would be home at, like, some certain time and be back before then and then go and sneak out in the middle of the night anyways.
I mean, yeah, if you've got a single parent, I went through a similar situation, but different circumstances. But yeah, if you want to get away with some shit, just tell your mom that drugs are super cool and that she should be doing them. Get your mom on drugs and you get away with all sorts of shit.
Till she's not around anymore.
Then you get away with even more. My dad lives like in a different city. He's busy.
Can you give me another beer, please?
If we're already starting on the dead mom jokes, you're going to need it.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, Clara's awesome, and I haven't even met her yet.
Like, yeah. There's two more points.
Okay.
So number two was, I'm not actually crazy. I just like to party sometimes, which I can understand that.
I
get that. You know, I've got some crazy party stories and shit. I mean, you know, we've all been there.
Yeah.
So, and number three... Oh, cool. It's the fucking double blend one that's like, what is the fucking, this one's 7.3. What's this one? That one's 5.5, and I think the regular one is 5.
Yeah.
And number three, I'm out with a giant group of boys because I'm one of the boys.
What was that one show? There was a whole show on like TBS or whatever that was like... about a girl who was one of the boys. Man, I'm so old now.
No idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, I'll figure it out.
You're like, yeah, I'm sure you don't.
I'll figure it out and then make a game based on old sitcoms that you know nothing about. That's what'll happen.
Her dad.
Yeah.
All right, sounds good. So, Clara, thank you for clarifying. I did not even... Like,
you were the worst.
I did not even...
Here's your dad.
I will take that gladly, actually. There's a face that Jim Carrey makes, and I don't know what movie it's from, but he's like sitting there like...
It's every single Jim Carrey movie.
So he's making that like, this is the face that he's making. Like, and I'm going to be that person or that dad, where it's like Christmas morning and like... Your kids, like, give you a gift, and so you, like, unwrap it, and you're like, oh, a cardboard box, just what I wanted. And they're like, Dad, you gotta open it. Like, that's gonna be me.
Yeah.
my whole life. Like, oh, yeah. I'm going to get Amelia with so much shit. Like, it's my whole life. It's just fucking with people. It's just my entire, like, that's my personality. It's, like, fucking around with people and having fun. Like,
I think that's why it makes you so mad when people get on your nerves, because your whole thing is that you get enjoyment out of getting on other people's nerves.
No, I don't get on your nerves. That's not my intent is not to get on your nerves. My intent is just to play around with you and to have fun. Y'all are just fucking annoying.
You have the advantage of seeing yourself from your viewpoint.
Which is the right point, okay? That is the right perspective.
All
right,
God complex. That's cool. That's fine. Reality is what you make it.
Exactly.
I thought we were all masters of our own reality.
No. You live in my reality.
I bet... I don't want to say that Clara seems like the person that would do some, like, backhanded shit, but I bet she is the one that gave us the 3-star review and then hit us up with, like, great podcast. Like, super funny. Did you see we had a 3-star review?
No.
Yeah, we have a 3-star review on iTunes.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do.
No, we don't.
Yes, we do, and they didn't say who they were.
It was anonymous?
It was just, yeah.
Or, like, some random fucking...
Yeah, it wasn't, like...
It was
like...
me.
It better not have fucking been you. I swear to God, we were going to fight now.
When we were fighting the other day, I was mad at you, and I was like, you know what's really going to piss him off? No, I'm just kidding. I didn't do that.
It probably hurts me more than it hurts him. Because then I see it, I'm like, what?
Where was it at?
Oh, no.
It's on iTunes.
Oh, they didn't write anything.
No, they just gave a star review.
Oh, you fucking asshole. Whoever the fuck you are, fuck you.
It's average. And then that's it.
You son of a bitch.
And they're not wrong. It is.
No. No, 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 no. We're like we are a 5-star podcast for what we are. We are a 5-star podcast. Don't you dare fucking dishonor this podcast right now.
No, it's... I mean, we're like the B-movie of podcasts.
That's exactly what we are, though.
Yeah.
Like, that's what we're supposed to be.
We're the campy B-movie that you fall in love with.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That you are supposed to fucking 5-star us on Apple.
Well, not everybody loves loves fucking, you know...
If you're not going to give me 5 stars, then don't fucking star it at all. Like, okay. Whoever that is, you're just being an asshole.
Right, some people didn't love Tucker and Dale versus Evil, okay? Like,
so you don't go write a review about it.
People only write reviews when they absolutely... Well, that defeats my point that I was about to make, but I was going to say either they absolutely love it or they absolutely hate it. There's no in between. But this is the one person that was just like, 3 stars. Like,
they were like, meh. I'll listen to it in my spare time.
Not a lot of people just put meh into the universe. It's either like one extreme or the other. This person just went, meh.
I guess thank you for not putting a 1-star and being like, it's not Joe Rogan. Like, this shit sucks.
That would infuriate me even more if it was just 1-star, no review. Like,
yeah. Yeah, at least if you're going to 1-star me, like, you better write a fucking review. Or they're like, this isn't YMH. Like, what the fuck? 1-star. I'd be so mad, dude.
We never claim to be YMH. We just like YMH.
And we copy a lot of their topics.
Yeah.
And we stole the TikTok idea from them, too, so...
A little bit.
But we can do that. That's not, like, trademarked that...
No. You know,
I'm sure there's other podcasts out there that do it, too, but YMH is just the one that me and you know about. So, well,
to go off my entertainment thing from earlier, like, it's like The Walking Dead had... The Talking Dead after it.
It was like a
show about a show.
Yeah.
We can be a show about a show. There's precedent for that.
I think that me and you could totally do like a YMH like recap podcast. Yeah. Like,
that'd be hilarious. Unofficial YMH recap.
Yeah, but who's gonna listen to it?
YMH fans.
You think?
I mean,
if you go and listen to the whole episode and then now you're going and listening to 2 fucktards talk about the episode that you just watched. You need to get a hobby other than listening to podcasts, okay?
Put it that way.
What other way is there to put it?
I thought we were pretty entertaining.
You were just bashing us saying that we deserve the 3-star review.
I didn't say we deserved it. Well, we are that type of podcast, though. We're a 3-star podcast. We don't deserve it. We deserve your 5 stars.
People that put the 5 stars, I can't thank you enough because we both know that it's not a 5-star. You're just helping a friend out is basically. Like, I'm sure that all of these people that have given us 5 stars and written a review are people that we, like, know.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like some random person that just, like, found us and then they were like, oh my god, this is funniest shit ever.
To be real, it's probably one of the CSGO people. podcast. Somebody who you just played randomly with and mentioned it to, and they listened to it. I know, like,
exactly
meh.
Who it is.
Oh, okay.
I do.
Yeah, detective work done. Solved.
It was. When did you see the review?
Like a week ago.
Ooh, a week ago? Maybe I don't know who it is.
It was last weekend.
Because I just today played a game with a dude, and I mean, I was doing pretty well. I was playing like a wingman, and I think I was like 10-1 at one point. Like, we were fucking, I was going off.
Yeah.
And he, like, puts in the chat, and he's like, oh, you're from Ohio? I was like, oh. He's like, what part? I was like, Seabus. He was like, Columbus, ? I was like, yeah. Right. And I was like, oh, where are you, you know, like, where are you from?
I'm from.
Or he was like, where'd you go to school? And I said Pickerington. And then he said he went to Orange.
I feel like Olentangy Orange.
Maybe that's it. But I told him, like, I added him because I was like, oh, you live in Ohio. Like, that's cool. Like, I always like to have local people to play with, even though you're fucking trash.
I like to look to camera.
I'd see us go. He is fucking trash. I was murdering these kids. Yeah. And they're like way higher ranks than I am in Wingman too. So like,
yeah,
I've been fucking murdering people. But anyway,
shooting gun video game.
So I like sent him a message after he added me as a friend and was like, hey, you should check out my podcast. And he was like, you only added me to tell me about your podcast. Was basically what his comment said. And I was like, well, you're from Ohio, so you'll get some of the, you know, local references that we talk about.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, we got to push the pod. What does he expect?
I mean, yeah. But I was going
to
say,
like, you're asking him to spend money or like,
right,
join a pyramid scheme.
I was like, we're on all major platforms and we're on YouTube too. So like, go check us out. And yeah. And I was going to say it would have been him because I fucking murked his ass. But what I thought was funny was that he checked my profile.
Yeah.
Because he probably thought I was cheating. And so, like, when people think that you're cheating, they'll go check your community profile. And then you can see people's games and how many hours that they put in on it. So he probably went, saw that I was from Ohio, and then checked my hours, saw that I had, like, 1,700 hours in CSGO, and then was like, oh, okay, now this dude's, like, legit. And he's from Ohio.
Yeah.
But I just thought it was funny that he went and checked my profile out because I was whooping his ass.
Right.
Okay. So I was going to say it was him, but if it was a week ago, then yeah, it was probably like some casual person where I was like...
Casuals.
Where I was like boosting the podcast and just like putting it on there, and somebody went on there and was like, yeah, fuck you.
Yeah, probably.
20 stars. Or it's somebody who's, like, legit critiquing us, and they're like, you guys could be better, which we definitely could, but I don't have the money, because nobody fucking donates to our Cash App, Venmo, or PayPal, at Blue Skies Pod.
Hell yeah. Good pivot there. Good plug.
Thanks, man. Thank you. I don't know, man.
What kind of beer are you drinking?
What kind of beer are you drinking,
60 Wes? Minute IPA. It's a Dogfish Head. It's kind of got, like, a little bit of, like, a cinnamony spice to it, like, very undertone. But it's very IPA, like,
oh,
it's pretty bitter.
Yuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
I love it.
That's good. It just looks really cool.
Yeah, Dogfish has cool logos, cool trucks. When I see their trucks drive around, they've got, like, the all black and white, like, skeleton fish logo.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna go into another shout out, because...
Shout out.
I got a new tattoo today.
Yes, you did.
As people can see by the shiny arm over here.
I was waiting to ask to see the full thing until we were actually on the pod.
Well, you can't really see it now.
No, I know.
Because, like, especially now with the Sanoderm on it, that it's just, it like, some of the ink bleeds out, and then it just makes it into, like, a glob. The photo that I sent you was probably the best that you're going to be able to see it until I take this shit off in 4 days.
You know, podcast, though.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I mean, it's fucking huge, though, dude.
Yeah,
like,
dude.
It goes, like, from here all the way up to here, and then, like, back here to all the way back around. Man,
yeah.
It's fucking... I love it, though. Like,
it's really cool.
I can't wait to take it off. Like, when he first did, like, the first, like, the actual, like, I forget what it's called, but, like, the stencil, like, yeah. I thought that that's just what he was gonna do. And then he went in with, like, the fine tip and added all these, like, small lines and shit. And I was like, that is dope.
Yeah.
Like, that is the extra flair that I needed on this thing. And, like, he definitely, like, accents it. Like, it just spreads it out a little bit more, and it just makes it look so much better.
But it's great peeking out from under the sleeve, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. See, that was another thing. And, like, where the sleeve sits is, like, right in the middle of the symmetry of it. So it's, like, it's just fucking perfect. Like, where it's placed at. And, like, I fucking love it. And he was charged about it, too. Speaking of who this is our buddy Cesar that we've known for years down at the skate park. You can check out his Instagram at scorpionspirit_. So scorpionspirit_. So you can check him out. And let me see where the fuck. Oh, he put me on his story.
Hell yeah.
What up?
Yeah, I saw you post about it already, too. I was on Instagram before I came over here. Oh, yeah. That looks great.
Yeah, I fucking love it, dude. Hold on, let me see if I can play it again. Cause...
Yeah, dude. That looks fantastic.
Yeah.
Especially fresh like that. Like, that looks really good.
He did a really good job with it. I really, really like it. Hold on. Let me go find his fucking shop because I want to... I know it's...
Oh, I just had it on the tip of my tongue when I was saying, too.
I know. It's Ink Empire.
Yeah.
And they are located at 4270 Groveport Road, Obetz, Ohio. If anybody would like to go to my buddy Cesar, but hit him up on Instagram. Check out some of his stuff. He's a really fucking great dude. Really happy that, like, he was charged about it, too. Like, when he got done with it, he was, like, you could see that he was, like, happy about it. Because he had been wanting to do this style. And that's what I told him, too. I was like, I want you to do something that you want to do that's, like, original to you. Like, that nobody else will have, you know. And, like, that's in a style that you would want to do. Like, I want you to be the most comfortable. Like, this can definitely be, like, a portfolio tattoo for you.
Yeah.
So, this is something that he's been wanting to do for a while now. And I just happen to be that person that was like, I will give you that opportunity, man. That's what I want from tattoo artists. I don't want the fucking... The flash sheet. And, the, you know, that...
Dude, fuck that.
50 other people have got out there. Like, if I'm going to get a tattoo and it doesn't really have, like, a lot of meaning to it, that it's not something specific that I want, then what I want is for the tattoo artist to come up with something that's original for them and that's, like, in the style that they would want to do it.
Yeah.
And, you know, like, whatever you're going to be the most comfortable in, you're going to have the most fun doing. And at the end of it, you act like Cesar. He was like, dude, this is awesome. He's
right.
Like, I fucking love this.
That's what you want to see is somebody who's, like, proud of what they've done. And also, I think we talked to our previous guest on the tattoo episode.
Dominic,
yeah. We talked to him about, like, the feeling of somebody walking around with, like, your art on their body. And, like, especially when you have just done it and you get to see, like, the final thing, like, how visceral that must be and how, like, you must get, like, a release of endorphins and stuff. Like,
oh, I'm sure.
When you feel good about it and you're like, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
I mean, shit, I'm already working on getting another one from him, so
yeah.
Hell yeah, man.
I definitely want to get one, or a couple from him in the future. When...
I told him that we're probably going to see each other a lot.
Yeah.
I was like, I might just start coming to you, and then I'll help you, like, also kind of spread out your style a little bit, too. Like, I'll start asking for some specific things just to kind of get you a little bit out of your comfort zone, and then I can kind of be that person, like, your blank canvas, because I'm not completely blank, obviously, but somewhat of a blank canvas for you to just do freely on, and then I'm not going to be mad about it.
Yeah.
Like, I already have two shitty tattoos, so.
That, I mean, while you're here, and that actually reminds me, speaking of shitty tattoos, and I kind of wish Cesar was here for this.
I know, I wish he was here too, but yeah, I'm sure
we'll get him on eventually. We'll have him on, and we'll talk to him about tattooing, and I'll tell him what I want, and
we'll
talk to him about other shit too, because we've had him on before, but it was one of the live episodes, so
you
guys go check that out.
Oh yeah.
But I do have a shitty tattoo game.
A shitty tattoo game. So how are we going to play this?
So, I have them in my Discord. I don't need the soundboard for it. So, I'm actually going to exit out of my soundboard now.
Okay.
I'm going to unplug that and unplug that. And I'm going to go to my Discord and pull up my game.
Okay.
So, I have all the pictures of these tats, and I will show them to you, and I will send them to you when we figure out what the correct answer for this is. But basically, the premise of the game is that I'm going to give you multiple choice, A, B, C, or D.
Okay.
Which of these is the real fucked up tattoo? Or no, sorry. Let me clarify, and I'm going to edit that part out. Let me clarify. Hey.
Hey.
Callback.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm keeping it.
We're not editing anything out now.
Making my job way easier and making it longer for me to listen to while I edit. Which one's the fake one? So there will be three real and one fake.
So we have to figure out which one is the fake one.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're going to describe three tattoos of like
I'm
going to
describe four tattoos.
Oh, okay. Four. Sorry. Yeah. Three fake or three real, one fake. Yeah. Okay,
let's get it right so that the listeners are on the same page.
No. We're good. We're good. Three real, one fake, and we have to figure out which one is the fake one. Now, are you going to describe where they're at, or are you just describing like what the tattoo is?
I have a one sentence, this is the tattoo, and this is where it is at for almost all of them.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, it's a spider on your butthole.
There's some spiders.
That's a real one.
I'm sure it is.
No,
I'm sure somebody's butthole is a spider. Oh,
it is.
Oh, I think you have told me about that one before.
Yeah. I think I showed you that one.
I feel like I showed you that one. I probably blocked that out.
We were probably drunk, too. Let's be real here.
Do you like his tattoo? Before we go into this, I wanted to ask you
what is your honest opinion about it, babe? Do you like it?
Well, like I told you before, it's not my style. It's not what I'm into. I like American traditional.
Yeah.
I think it's really awesome.
It sounds like you don't like it.
No, I think it looks cool on you. I just wouldn't personally get it for myself.
Well, yeah, does that mean that I wouldn't? I'm asking you though.
But yeah, I like it. I do like it. I think that if it's your style, it's your aesthetic, for sure. And it does look good.
He did a great
popping
job
popping out of your sleeve.
Yeah, I really like that. And we talked about different areas and stuff that we were gonna do it Back of the calf was going to be one of them, on my left leg.
That would have hurt.
Yeah, that one would have hurt. Yeah. Or...
You should get a back of the thigh tat.
Ooh, that's going to hurt.
Only if I can get your name.
we should go get butt tattoos.
There's some great butt tattoos on the internet that you can find. I looked at a lot of back tattoos.
Can we clarify, please? I will get a butt cheek tattoo.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because we've seen... Well, y'all haven't seen it.
Oh, you mean a tattoo of a butt?
No.
Whole tattoo?
A butthole tattoo. Oh, yeah. Okay.
There was one that I saw that somebody had on their forearm, just a lady shitting, full-on naked, squatted from the behind, view, just shitting on a sidewalk with somebody's tattoo. I was cool.
Was that
cool.
that show where your friend picks out a tattoo for you and you're blindfolded for it?
That might be where some of these came from. I didn't do any research on who these people were. I found jacked up tattoos.
Would you want to do that?
I don't think my wife would let me.
We each pick out a tattoo for each other. We can't tell each other what it is.
But I could get away with it.
Blindfolded for it. Let's say we get it on our legs.
Yeah.
So somewhere, you wear pants all the time anyways, nobody's ever going to fucking see it.
That's true.
Except for your wife.
Yeah.
Which then I could make it specific to your wife.
I have pearlescent legs. I wear pants so often.
Do you wear pants in the swimming pool?
I'm not the dude that wears the shirt in the pool. I wear full-on jeans. No shirt, jeans. No boxers. Fucking commando. Jeans in the pool.
That's what's up. Yeah, if you send me the photo... Of the fake one?
You in jeans in the pool?
Wait, how are you sending me the photo of a fake one?
Oh, well, I will send you the photos of the three real ones.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you send those to me, I can put them up on the...
Yeah, exactly.
On the video, yeah.
That's why I did it this way.
What up?
So you guys will get to see the real bad tattoos, and you'll just have to imagine the fake one that I came up with.
Heard that.
Yeah.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
I like it.
This is going to be great. Yeah. All right, let's get into it.
All right. A real tattoo or nope? Which one's fake? Round one.
Okay.
Animal edition.
Animal edition.
Animal edition. All right. Connect the freckles, snake, back tattoo. Connect the dots, but connect the freckles.
So, side story to this. My grandma Ballantyne, while she was dying of cancer in her bed, I would she'd only want one kid in there at a time because it was just overwhelming to have more than one person in there at a time. So when I would go back, she would always say that she wanted to take a Sharpie and connect all the freckles on my face. And I should have fucking let her, man.
Yeah.
Because I know it would have made her happy, but rest in peace. Anyways.
All right. So that's A. Connect the freckles, snake back dad.
That one's real.
Full face, giant spider hugging your, like, it's on your nose, but it's like full-size face tattoo, like your whole face is being hugged by this spider.
That one's real. The dude's probably bald, too.
I don't remember. C.
Well, bicep. Thanks for giving that one away.
Well, I could be throwing you off.
Who cares?
Yeah.
It's real.
Bicep tat of a unicorn being butt-fucked by a dragon.
That one's real, too.
Or, final one, belly tat of a cat, but the belly button is the asshole of the cat.
No, I've seen that. I know for a fact that one's real. Mm-hmm. So, fuck. Maybe the spider one. You're gonna go with C, the unicorn? I feel like that one's like... I feel like I've seen that one, too. What was the first one again?
I'm sure the fake ones that I've come up with exist somewhere. It's just that I didn't see them. So the first one is connect to Freckles, snake.
I'll say that one's the fake one, because all the other ones sound like they're real.
Okay.
Send me the real one.
So let me
scroll. Wait, what did you said C, the unicorn getting fucked by a dragon? I feel like that one's definitely real.
Well, that's what I'm going with.
All right.
Final answers?
Yep. I'm A, she's C.
C. It was C is the fake one.
Damn, I'm salty. Well,
I was not confident at all.
I know what my next tattoo is going to be.
Okay, so honesty. Connect the freckles.
Oh, my God. Hold on, you guys. Hold on. Let me open
this up. If you haven't seen the cat butthole, that one's real.
So there is the
snake. That's a nice cat.
Right? They did a great job on the cat.
Connect the dots. The cat one, like I said, I've seen. Oh, you can't see. That one's like super small. And the.
Oh, yeah. These are just grabbed from Google.
Yeah. That one's fucking stupid.
That one's the most fucked up.
The spider face one is easily like, dude, why?
That's so terrifying.
Yeah. Thank you. That and it's just like, thought you just ruined your whole life.
He has like, his whole nose is black.
Like, I'm not saying, like, I likes, like,
I like
a good amount. Yeah, I honestly think they're pretty cool. When they're done like well, when it's like around your face, like especially the ones that are like up on your forehead, like around your eyebrow. But a full face tattoo of a spider is just like a little bit excessive.
Do you think he got that? No.
This next round definitely has some face tats.
I was going to say, did he get that in fucking jail? But no.
No, I mean, somebody actually put some time and effort into that. Like, that's one of those ones that, like, he might have had a couple sessions done.
That's ridiculous.
To commit to that is
this is the
nuts.
Point where, like, you as a tattoo artist, and we talked about this with Dominic, where he was like, no. Where you have to be like, no.
Yeah, it was his buddy that did that or something.
Sir or woman, ma'am. I'm going to need you to reevaluate your life decisions right now and realize that this is not one of the decisions that you want to go with.
Yeah.
Because that's just fucking dumb, in my opinion. Now, who knows? Maybe his nickname now is Spider-Man, and everybody loves him.
That's probably what it is. Maybe his name is Miles Morales. He's the white Miles. You don't know who that is. Okay, you don't. You see, you don't like Spider-Man. You don't do superheroes, you fucking asshole. Well, now I'm mad at you. All right, round two. This is the dumb edition.
Dumb edition?
So we did animals. Mm-hmm. This is now dumb edition.
You'll probably be really good at this one, babe.
All right, first
straight
one.
Straight to the heart.
I took it as a compliment. Like, he knows dumb really well. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, she was calling me fucking dumb.
Well, it does take one to...
Real recognize real? Yeah. Fuck you. Fuck both of you.
All right. Gaming headset microphone tatted along the jawline. B. Inner lip tattoo. Like this.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Says meow.
Of the inside of your lip?
Yep.
Okay.
C is mustache replacement style. So like... where your mustache would go, split in the middle and everything, with like a little twist at the end. Pussy eater. Or D, removed eyebrows and replace them with wrongfully convicted in script lettering.
Hmm.
I'll run through them real quick again. Gaming headset jawline, inner lip meow, mustache pussy eater, or eyebrow wrongfully convicted.
See, I feel like the last one is real, because that was definitely a prison tattoo. See, this is me thinking about too much, and then I start explaining, like, why I think that each one, and I just need to answer it.
I'm going to say A is fake.
I think that it's A2. I don't think that... I would hope that somebody doesn't get a gaming mic, and I feel like you put that in there for me.
Yeah. 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 I did. You're 2 for 2. You got one.
Hell yeah! Got one. Okay, let me see these other ones, man. I gotta see them. All
right, here they come.
Oh, jeez. Oh, it's a white dude, too. You fucking...
Wrongfully convicted one is probably my favorite of the bunch.
Oh, my God.
At least they don't make him look, like, surprised all the time. At least they're, like...
Yeah.
They're kind of good-looking eyebrows.
Yeah.
And they'll grow back at some point, too, right? His eyebrows?
He's gonna keep shaving them. That tattoo's on fleek.
Oh. Oh, wait a minute. I thought... I didn't catch that. When you were explaining the replacement mustache, I thought you were, like, literally talking about somebody got a mustache, like, tattooed. Like a replacement mustache. I didn't know that there was the words pussy eater as their mustache.
Like some people just like
don't
want a job, I guess. I don't know who would hire somebody with that tattoo. Like,
so he's apparently killed 2 people because he's got the double teardrop. Yeah. And he also has fuck you tattooed in beautiful script on his scalp.
Well, I guess he just doesn't care.
Clearly not. But what's funny is that the white guy was like in a prison fucking outfit with, like, clearly, like, a mugshot. And this dude's just, like, at a shop.
Yeah.
Like, with pussy eater on his top lip.
The last lady that has meow looks like she's gonna die alone with nothing but cats.
Aww.
Yeah. She got that tattooed on her inner lip because she wants her cats to lick it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I really wanted to like, copy Bam and get the heartogram tattoo on the inside of my lip, but... I'm not going to do it.
You got to get those, like, updated all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do. Because
lip skin grows back too quick.
Yeah. Which I'd be fine with. That just means that I get to go see, you know, a tattoo artist every now and again.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, hey, can we do this tattoo? And then when you're done, can you just, you know, run over this real quick? It'll take them fucking 5 minutes to run over my lip real quick. Like, that'll just be added to the part of the session. Every time I go get another tattoo, I'm just like, hey, can you touch this up? And then there you go.
Right.
But no.
It's still a commitment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which I'm not. Which is obviously why I don't have it.
Yeah. It was one of the... Did you guys watch the Blade movies?
Yeah, we talked about the...
No.
We were talking about that music that you were showing me.
Oh, yeah. It sounded like the Blade techno.
In the club, when they're in the club.
When it starts raining blood.
Yeah.
What?
The first Blade, pretty early on, it's one of the first scenes. There's like a rave happening in a nightclub, and like this chick takes a dude there, and then you find out she's a vampire that lured just a human there, and then blood starts coming out of the sprinklers from the ceiling, and then like the lights start flashing like strobe style, and they all just eat this dude in the middle of the dance floor. It's like the beginning of Blade.
It's a vampire club. Like there are a bunch of vampires.
And you find out that they if the sneaky ones have their like insignia on their inner lip. And that was like one of my main problems with the movie is like, show me the vampire tattoo artist that's updating this every few weeks for all these fucking vampires so that they know who each other is. Like,
I mean, they probably got multiple ones.
I'm sure they do, but show me it. If that's going to be part of your lore. True. It's probably in the comics, but whatever.
Maybe vampire tattoos don't fade as fast.
Oh, shit.
Ooh.
Maybe vampire cells don't regenerate. They're that. Hell yeah. See, this is why you're on the podcast. You're smarter than both of us.
I don't know about that.
Thank you for realizing that.
We both just say dumb shit, and then she's like, this is funny and correct.
True. Whoa. Well,
hey.
Whoa.
Windows noises.
Yeah. Wish I could turn that off. That's not a thing. Okay, so next round.
This is the last round. Oh, so
there's only 3 rounds?
Yeah, well, this was a little more time consuming.
Oh, okay, fair enough.
I had to go through a lot of really bad tattoos that I wish I could show you all of, but it would take a long time to send them all.
We should do that sometime. I mean, you should just sit down in a Discord some night, and we'll just share a screen and then go and look at all the shitty tattoos.
Yeah, I really liked that one night that we did that with Fleer, where, like, we were all just chatting, and, like, I was...
You were going through,
I was hosting a Google session where, like, we pulled up... It was some random search engine.
You just type in something random, like, random numbers or something like that? Because it was, like...
It was a random image search.
Yeah. So you type in, like, just something random, and then it shows you all the images that have like those letters and numbers in it or something like that. Yeah.
And there was like people's personal photos that they accidentally uploaded publicly to places, and now you can just find them on the internet. And we were just making fun of shit. That was a lot of fun. Oh my God.
Yeah. We were having a great time.
Yeah. All right. Round three, final round, offensive edition.
Ooh.
Had to save this one for last. These ones are people who chose to get literally the most offensive thing they could possibly get tatted on their body permanently.
So swastikas.
That might be one of them. Did I choose to? We'll see. All right. A. 9/11. Government conspiracy.
Here's one of them compared to 9/11.
Jet fuel doesn't melt. Steel. All right. 9/11. 9/11. Claiming Twin Towers on the leg. With the text, "It's raining men." And there's like burning bodies falling out of the building. Tattooed on like where you were going to get yours. Imagine that. But instead, it's the burning Twin Towers with people jumping from it, and then it's raining men underneath.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that one's, I like that. Now, I don't like that one.
That one's fucked up.
I did chuckle at how stupid that person is, though, when I saw it. B, suicide bomber gear tatted around the midsection. So, like, full-on dynamite and clock strapped to the body, and the timer says 3 seconds left. You guys are both uncomfortable during this round. Yes. I like it. This is my comfort zone.
I'm just trying to think. Keep my head in the game.
Before we get too late, because I'm gonna start the TikToks after this. Send me all the TikToks that you have.
Hell yeah! Look at that. You're on top of shit.
Yeah.
All right. So A, flaming Twin Towers. It's raining men. B, suicide bomber gear tatted around the midsection.
Yeah.
So when this guy takes his shirt off, he's a suicide bomber.
Oh my God.
Portrait of Snooki on forearm after she got punched in the eye that one time. So that full on.
That one's totally real.
Full on black eyes.
I hope so.
Because people who watch Jersey Shore are fucking crazy.
Because it's the best.
No, it is not. I fucking hated that show. It was the most stupidest show ever. They were literally paid to act like a fool.
They did a Silent Library episode.
I know.
It was great.
Now that would have been
such good trash.
Mm-hmm. Now that I could watch. Great but like content. The actual Jersey Shore fucking show, no. That shit was so fucking dumb. Why do I want to watch people go get fucked up and then yell and scream at each other over dumb shit when I can just go do that in my regular life and experience it myself?
The kids I sat at lunch with in high school at one point were giving each other Jersey Shore nicknames. So, like, we called each other, like, the bicep. Like, like Johnny the Bicep Davis. Like, Jersey Shore was the shit, dude. Fuck you. Oh, it's not plugged in. I just tried to own you with a drop.
Do you want me to go into your whole high school experience right now? Because we've got multiple things that make you the biggest nerd I've ever met in my entire life.
We were talking about magic on the last episode, and I used to go around from table to table and do card tricks for girls I thought were pretty.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
You wrote poems for chicks.
Yeah. One time I wrote a poem and then put it in red watercolor and then splattered red watercolor over it and then crumpled it up a bunch of times and unfolded it a bunch of times so that it felt like toilet paper. You know when people would do that where they would make it feel like toilet paper? So that it looked like it was like blood-stained cloth with a poem written on it? Why am I telling you this on the podcast?
I don't know.
You didn't even need to say anything. I just fucking outed myself more.
You were like, oh yeah, and I've done this. Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all I have. Sorry, just one.
You were...
It's all good.
Me and you would have been best friends, though. That's the only problem is that, like, me and you would have been really good friends.
Yeah. Like, and people would have judged you for hanging out with me.
And they already judged me for me just being me in the first place, so it would have been fine.
Yeah.
It would have worked out. I didn't judge you.
You... Shut up.
I didn't judge you ever in high school.
We barely talked in high school.
Oh, I didn't judge you.
Well, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
I didn't judge you either.
That's good.
Did I ever tell you guys that I used to think the lyric was, it's too late to call a judge?
What? No.
No way. How do you get
it's too late to call a judge from it's too late to apologize?
When I was 14 and naive.
And had bad hearing, apparently. Yeah.
know. What?
I just saw the curtains move.
Susan?
Maybe?
Oh, no, she's right there.
Either that was a glitch in the Matrix, or I just saw the curtains move.
Like, did they scooch a little bit? Or did they, like, go like this? Because my back's to them. Fuck you. Like, we were already talking about a ghost earlier. Like, I'm not doing this shit. I ain't scared of no ghosts.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I just feel like I saw a move and, like...
Dude, fuck you.
I'm sorry.
This side's, like, pulled out towards me and shit. Like...
And it was over there, though. It was over on the other side. Yeah. Are you sure you closed Amelia's door all the way?
I mean, we would have hurt her, right?
Yeah, maybe. If she decided to climb out of the thing.
I'm gonna go look.
Be able to open the door.
I'm not looking.
I'm not fucking looking. We're in the middle of a podcast. I'm the one that's on camera, okay?
So?
I'm so terrified right now.
I didn't lock the front door when I came in.
You son of a bitch.
Honesty's leaving.
No, I gotta go check. God damn it, dude.
I'm remembering that I didn't because I didn't think about it. Bitch. Austin dies. And then it's just me and you and the dog, and we're gonna figure out what the fuck. I'm no good. Like, I'm not gonna be. We're dead.
Fuck.
He was our. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, let's be real here. If anybody was gonna save you guys, or if anybody was gonna help save anybody, it'd be me saving y'all, dumbass.
Seriously, we shouldn't have sent you, because you're the only one that'll help the other one survive that's left after one of us gets killed. Fuck. Oh, that was legit terrifying, guys. Did the camera see it move? I'll have to watch to see if, like, there was a rustling in the video.
I'm telling you, either my eyes are fucking with me, or that really happened.
Did that just happen?
That's what I'm saying. I was like, either it was a glitch in the Matrix and, like, I just reset, or that bitch moved. Okay? Just saying.
Maybe it was just settling. I don't know. Like, maybe it, like, was stuck on the wall and scooched a little bit or something. I don't know.
Maybe. Yeah. Okay. Back to whatever the fuck we were doing before.
Final round.
Before we all die from whatever that was.
Offensive edition. Flaming towers on the leg with its raining men.
Uh-huh.
Suicide bomber gear tatted around the midsection.
Uh-huh.
Portrait of Snooki on forearm after he got punched in the eye that one time.
We know for a fact that one's real.
Or... I heart on one eyelid, Hitler on the other. When you close your eyes, it's the full thing.
Who?
Let me get those ready to send.
Who?
I think D is fake.
I don't think so. I don't think that D is fake. So we know C and D are real.
Snooki and I heart Hitler. I heart Hucka Hitler.
So I'm going to go with B because I think that A... is real.
All right, Hitler bees? Whatever. Nobody's going to get that reference. Nobody that listens. Maybe your dad.
Maybe.
What's up, dad?
So I'm going to go with B.
B?
Yeah.
Your wife is way too good at games. You should always just go with her when we play a game that doesn't have a guest.
Good point.
Yeah.
No, I make my own decisions.
Yeah. No, you're your own man, and yes. I respect that about you. I'm going to send the three that are correct.
Oh my fucking god. No fucking way.
There's the bombs around the midsection. This guy's a real G.
Like, what? No, hold on. Before you keep going.
He also has bars in the nips that I like that.
Like, he's got the nipple piercings. Okay.
Mate, one
but
good decision.
What was the reason for you...
Or two, like, good decisions.
What was the thought process with you getting that? Like what... What in your life led up to the point where you were like, I'm going to get a suicide bomber strap?
Are you questioning, like, this man's religion?
I am questioning this man's life decisions.
He's a jihadist. That's why he got it.
That looks like a white dude. That looks like a Kyle, bro.
There's white jihadists.
That's a Kyle. You can't see it.
Is that what we're calling Karens now?
You can't see it, but Karens, he's got a monster in his hand that he's holding, okay?
There was some really good monster tattoos that I almost put in the game. It was almost round four. There was a dude who had the monster text like in their font on his forehead.
No way.
It was great. And then he had a monster cheek tattoo, like the three nails. All right. Here's the Snooki one, which this looks like the person has a real bruise on their body and then got a tattoo over it. Almost.
It does.
Wow.
The artist was pretty good, though. I can't lie.
That's what I really wish Cesar was here for this, because every single one of these, I wanted his opinion on whether or not it was actually good work.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then probably the most fucked up of all of them. At least they're stick figures. You gotta give them that. But it's also not the best work, and the color could have been better.
Who the fuck gets this shit? Obviously a white dude.
Well, it's like what we were talking about. You blindfold your friend and then have them get a secret tattoo and somebody's friend is a neo-Nazi and they didn't find out until then.
I would fucking murder you. I would literally murder you, like, right then. If that's the secret tattoo. Because I feel like when I said that, I felt like me and you, we would get each other tattoos that we would want.
Yeah.
Or that we would think that we would want. Like, if it might not, like, you might not necessarily, like it, but it'll still be a dope tattoo. And you'll be like, oh, I can appreciate that it looks cool, even though, like, maybe I didn't really want this type shit, you know?
Yeah.
It's not going to be something like that where you're like, this is fucked up.
Let me find, there was one that I almost included in the game when you said swastikas. It's almost clever, because I've never thought about LOL like that. But it's definitely upsetting.
Oh, that's just sad.
That's definitely like a 4chan internet troll.
That's just sad. Whatever that is, your life is a fucking failure, dude.
There's some real good ones, though. If you just type most offensive tattoo into Google, you come up with some good shit.
I'm sure you can.
A lot of people get full-on McDonald's receipts on their forearms, and that came up a lot. Like, there were several of those. And I was like, is this the same McDonald's receipt that I'm seeing? And no, they're all different ones.
The only time that I would ever get a receipt like that is if I went to, like, McDonald's or Taco Bell and bought one of everything on the menu and then took that receipt and took it to a shop and then was like, put this, like, down my ribcage.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you should do that. You should get a fast food receipt tattooed on your body at some point. And you're like, no, those are smart decisions. We're making smart decisions at all times. If you listen to us, you know to take our advice because we make smart decisions.
If anybody would ever question you, you could pull your credit card out and be like, look, these are the last four digits of my credit card. Look at the receipt.
You're trying real hard to come up with a good reason for this.
I didn't need a good reason. I bought one of everything on the fucking menu. That was a good enough reason. You're really fucking pushing my buttons here, man.
I like pushing your buttons.
Fuck you.
You should like it, too.
I do.
Oh, ooh, ooh. Ooh. Hey.
Ooh. All right, everybody take a deep breath.
Dude, there's a ghost. I can't fucking... I'm still hot.
It was after that one shit that happened to you at work.
Yeah.
Where your, like, hair got pulled down your fucking shirt.
I believe in ghosts now.
No shit, really?
Did you hear that story?
I've heard that story.
Okay, yeah.
It's scary.
Fuck that. And I didn't before that happened, and now it's just like, I don't know. I wish they would fuck with me more so I could be sure. But not like that.
No, yeah, that was creepy.
Yeah.
So, TikToks?
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody ready?
I'm down for some TikToks.
I'm trying without fucking everything up.
I'm going to try since I'm actually going to unplug all this again. And because my phone's actually charged this time.
I don't know how well. Oh, yeah, you can see that, right?
Yep.
Okay.
We're good. Go ahead.
All right. You ready?
Yep.
You ready?
Let's do these TikToks.
Here we go. TikTok.
Austin's TikTok corner.
Kevin, is this your boat? It's actually my dad's, but he just said I could use it because he's never home.
Yeah, man, that must be nice.
Having a boat?
No, dad.
I thought that one was pretty good.
My dad
lie.
Got me this cool boat. Anytime anybody talks about their mom.
Yep. God, your life is just...
The best?
Shit. Dude.
At all times?
Your life is just straight shit.
Did I tell you my apartment tried to tow my car for no reason?
Yes. Yes, you did.
God yes, you damn did. It.
This one is for Jacob.
Yeah, I see some scoot scoots.
This is for scoot scoots out there. Scoot 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 scoot. Okay, this is for you, scoot scoots. Love you. Keep scooting. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Shout out, Jago.
Yeah, baby, you don't really need to watch this one, but.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
So it was like a.
Wow.
Scooter flip 360, and then whatever the fuck that last part is.
I want to see it again.
I got you.
I'm sorry, but I was expecting a bail. God damn, he did like a fucking 360 body varial with a scooter flip at the end.
Wow. It's crazy. That shit was just
nuts.
It was nuts, dude. I was like, holy shit, like, I got to put that on there just for Scoot Scoots.
Yeah.
Scoot Scoots needs to see that.
What's up, Jacob? Hope you're watching.
He'll be like, oh my God. Oh, hey, this video actually is for both of you. Right now, I was just gonna say it's for Wes, but yeah.
You a bitch. You know why you a bitch? Cause I said so. You just a bitchy bitch. You a bitch McBitcherson. You a bitch McBitch. You, I go to McDonald's and get a McBitch because you a bitch. Bitch.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, fuck me, dude.
What? What'd you do?
I got too excited.
Oh, did you not?
I didn't show the people.
Oh, we gotta show the people.
I didn't show the people.
You a bitch. You know why you a bitch?
Yeah.
Cause I said so. You just a bitchy bitch. You a bitch.
First time I'm hearing this.
You a bitch McBitch. You, I go to McDonald's and get a McBitch because you a bitch.
This is why you're showing. I'm a bitch. We're bitches.
I'm so sorry, people. I'm so sorry. I'm just terrible at my job.
This is why people listen to the show, though.
Because we fuck up all the time?
Yeah, no, there's a charm to it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
She looks like I'm going to be annoyed by her already.
So here's some pretense to this one.
Okay.
The description for it said, for all intents and purposes, this is a joke.
All intensive purposes?
Yes.
Yeah. It's a blessing in disguise.
But I just want you to understand...
In the blue skies?
...that this does not prove anything. Okay?
Okay. It's called a sack.
This does not... Say it with me.
It does
this
not...
This does not prove...
Prove...
Anything.
Anything.
Okay.
I do.
You ready? Are you ready for this, Wes?
Hey, I hear you pee your pants. Maybe I do, so?
Then do it then!
No, that proves everything.
No, it doesn't.
You made me repeat it like it was some sort of contract that I was signing.
Because
like, you're going to turn me into a human centipede,
no,
but no.
Exactly what it was. You said it on the podcast. That did...
You're such a fucking
fuck
dick because I didn't know what I was signing up for.
Fuck you.
No, fuck you. When you die, nothing happens. Fuck you.
So, I already agree with you on that.
Yeah, I know, I said that. I was like, well, like, he's Christian? I don't know. He's a Dane Cook fan? I don't know.
So, yeah, it doesn't prove anything, but that one was for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Babe, this one's for you.
For proving my point and then being a dick about it?
Yeah, that doesn't prove anything.
Jack, want to play the peg game?
What?
The peg game.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, yeah, sure. Okay.
Okay, so you take this and then you jump each of the pegs and then you have to leave one in. Your turn.
That peg game.
So cute. That was cute. Dirty cute.
Yeah, that one made me giggle and think of my wife.
My wife really wants to peg me, and I'm slowly coming around to it.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do it. I mean, you don't have to get anything like super big either.
You and the internet have been slowly convincing me. I mean, between you and the internet, you're doing about a 50-50 job between the two of you, and I'm almost there. I mean, just need somebody that listened to the show to just, like, shove me over the edge, and I'm getting fucking butt-fucked by my wife.
I saw a post today that it was like, if a dude likes getting pegged by his girlfriend, is he gay?
No, he's more of a man.
You say, what? Whoa.
If you're willing to let your wife be in the dominant position, or whoever you're dating, which, if that's even how you look at it, but if you allow her to take the normally masculine role of being the one who's doing the pushing, then yeah, you're saying, I'm man enough to step aside and let you be in that role. I think. Some people would look at it as being weaker or being a cuck, but I hate the term cuck.
Yeah. No, same. And, like, I saw a lot of posts on there in the comments that were like, that dude has, like, fucked a dude before. I was like, so now you're technically, like, speaking out of context here and bringing up hypotheticals and saying that dude could have never fucked a dude before, never sucked a dick, nothing, like, ever, never been attracted to a male, but just likes the anal stimulation. But, like, there's just people out there that just don't have the fucking processing power in their fucking brain to understand that. Like, well, I mean, with me, I'm fucking bisexual, so it's a whole different thing. But now when we're coming to you, who's somebody who's a straight male, but you're, like, slowly coming around to it, and it's like, I don't know how far you've gone with things up your butt, but...
Oh, we've talked about it before. About a Sharpie.
Oh, yeah. So, that's not too bad.
I uncapped a Sharpie with my asshole.
It is different, though, when you've got something bigger up there. That's just, this is a whole new thing when, like, you almost feel like you're pooping. And so, like, part of the way through it, you're like, am I pooping right now? Or is my wife pegging me?
Okay, you're slowly backing me out of wanting to do this. Because I don't want to be questioning whether or not I'm pooping.
No. It's just a weird feeling. Like, yeah. It's just like,
I already have enough of wondering whether or not I'm pooping in
you
my
get
life.
You get over that. Oh, really?
I don't need more.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, same.
We'll talk about it later.
We'll get there. But
it's basically like, I don't want to hear myself talk. It's basically
weird.
You're like, oh no, like, what if I'm like pooping? And then you're like, oh, this feels really good. Then you're like, well, it's my like significant other. Like, he saw me birth a baby. So if I poop on him, then.
If I was going to poop on anybody, I would just be happy that it's her.
I'd poop on you, is what your relationship is.
Yeah.
And that's what me and my wife are slowly working towards. We're going to get matching shirts that say, I'd gladly poop on you.
Me and her were literally talking about this the other night, where I was like, do you think that we're going to get to the point in our sex life, like at some point, anytime down the road, like if we spend the rest of our lives together, do you think that we'll get to the point where we start like pissing and pooping on each other?
Scatological.
At the beginning of the night, it was a no. At the end of the night, it was a, I don't know, because some things happened that night.
It's a long journey, and we'll see when we get there.
And, we didn't, like, poop or pee on each other, but some other things happened, and we were like, yeah, I feel like we could get there at some point, like, probably, like, 20 or 30 years down the line. I'm like, all right, go ahead, shit on my chest, it'll make me hard. So you don't need to watch this one, because you sent me this one. But this is the TikTok that my wife has sent me.
Awesome.
So I have no idea what this one is.
It's an honesty talk.
It's an honesty talk. This is really what you... This is what you were like, the podcast needs this.
Yeah.
She's like, I looked at TikTok for 10 minutes, and this is the one.
No, I'm on TikTok a lot.
She said she had a whole bunch the other day.
I thought I did.
And now she's like, were scrolling through, that's the one you chose to say. I love it. I fucking love it.
Da-da-da-da! You don't need to see the video. You can just hear it.
Oh, my God. No, you need to see the video.
For the people just listening. This woman abuses her children.
That is definitely not abusing. He came up with that idea. And then his mom was just cool enough to be like,
she is stone-faced, breaking his ears.
That is true. That is true.
And he's screaming through it. The only reason he's yelling like that is because both his eardrums are bursted. Originally, when they were first doing, because this is like their sixth take.
Is there some blood coming out of his ear?
Yeah. When this is like their sixth take, when they were first doing it, he was beautiful. He was like an operatic singer. He sounded just like the trumpet. By the end of it, he's just fucking tone deaf. Yeah. Sounds like me doing it.
This is the exact opposite of that father and son where the dad has the trombone and his son's like opening and closing the oven. And he's like, do, 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 do. And then his son chimes in with the oven. Yeah, that was kick ass. Dude, get the fuck out of here.
No, let her be.
Just keep getting stepped on then, bitch. I don't give a shit.
My under tits are sweating from that TikTok.
Oh my god. That's the one that got you though. None of mine get you, but my wife is over here fucking making your tits sweat.
She gets me.
I'm so fucking done with this fucking night with both of y'all. Like, I'm fucking tired of it. I'm just I can't with either of you. I'm so
do you need a vacation?
I need a blowy.
You don't get one.
Oh, fuck. That was the wrong time to say that, huh?
Well, you gotta blow yourself.
I can't.
We'll figure it out.
I've tried.
I've tried too. I'm too. I've always been too fat.
I'm just not that flexible. I'm not fat like you. I'm just not that flexible.
I can't. This relates to the poop story. And why I didn't know that I'd pooped is because I keep getting fatter, and every time I get bigger, like I go through phases of my life where I fluctuate up and down, and I'm at my fat phase now, and I keep getting bigger, and the part of the problem is that my thighs start to touch, and I get chafed, and I have to like take extra care to like dry things when I'm done showering and stuff like that.
Just put some baby powder down there. Yeah. Or actually deodorant. Your deodorant?
Yeah. Yeah, no, I do things like that, but occasionally, I just won't have the time to do it, and I'll get chafed. So, yeah. I'll get to the point where, like, I'm wet and kind of, like, scratchy and fucking burny down there. And
I love when you get wet.
I'm so wet all the time.
I like how you, like, fucking gripped the microphone, too. Like, it was a dick, and that's what's making you wet?
I'm so wet.
Don't look at my wife and do that. That was not appropriate.
She looked away.
That was not appropriate.
She's side-eyeing me.
That was not appropriate at all. When you leave, my wife's going to be like, Wes isn't allowed over anymore.
Honesty. I get so wet.
I'm so sorry. I mean, it happens to everybody. Yeah. So, I mean, hopefully.
What?
Like, it rains, and then you have to run out to your car, and you get wet.
Oh, while it's raining, your wife asked you to put the cover out on your back porch.
Well, you should have done it before it started raining.
And then it stops raining.
Well, now it'll help me in the hot sun tomorrow. Thanks.
Yeah, you're fucking welcome.
You're so nice.
I know. I'm the best fucking husband ever. I know.
Wow.
I know.
So I was at work all day. And
you're talking about your poop story.
Yeah. And
sorry, I forgot to care.
So it was one of those days where I was a little chafy, and I was like the beginnings of it, and I was like, well, this is no good. I'm gonna have to go home and fix this. But when I got home, I was just like ready to relax and sit down. So like I sat down at the computer, and Crystal usually gets home like half an hour after me with the kids. So she gets home, and I get up to help her, and I realize like, oh, I'm still a little like puddly down there. So I reach because I stood up and it's
wait a minute.
When you're in your house,
puddly, puddly.
Yeah, I'm throwing a puddle.
Can you describe that to me just a little bit more?
You ever watch Peppa Pig?
No.
Jumping in muddy puddles.
Oh, dude, I can picture that though.
You love jumping in my muddy puddle.
Well, that's not for.
We can pick the story back up.
Moving on.
If you want to take a break, you look like you're about done.
My back
you
just hurts.
No, she's just standing up. Finish your fucking story, and then we'll take a break.
Okay. Cliffhanger? Okay, fine. Fuck. Poop hanger? So.
Is that like a poop spoon?
It's like when you get a poop abortion. Poop hang. That's so bad. So I'm Wait a so minute. Sorry.
What? Like when you're like what? Constipated.
No. Yes.
And
no.
you can't afford like constipation medication, so you just like use a hanger to get
yes,
the poop out.
Exactly. See, no, you're on.
I know.
Yes,
I get it. I do
yes.
that all the time.
What the fuck is wrong with both of you?
I had a it was my fucked up grandfather that I don't talk to anymore. He had a grandmother that was like 90 and so constipated that she was telling a story one time when we were at family's house.
You got something on your lip. Oh, you just licked it into your mouth and I feel like it was glitter because my wife did a photo shoot the other day.
No, she told me about it. You got glitter on your face too.
Do I really?
I was like,
God damn it!
You were all over your wife with your face.
The answer is yes.
I heard the story, then saw the glitter, and was like, oh. Anyway, she dug, 90-year-old dug poop out of her ass.
It was just on your lip. Sorry.
Anyway. With her finger and was telling the story at like a holiday gathering. Anyway, poop story set aside for another poop story. So I'm home from work. Crystal gets home with the kids. I stand up. I stick my hand down my pants like I normally do when I stand up in my own house. I'm so excited about this.
Fucking figured out.
And then I scratch through the boxers, not bare ass, but you know, you stand up, you scratch your ass when you're at your house. And then I smell my fingers like I normally do. And I go, that's not sweat.
Ooh.
That smells a little more dank than usual. Like, that's some fire. Like, that's some good butt I got growing in my fucking cheeks, bro. Fucking loud.
No. That's some mid shit, okay? Because it's brown and it's fucking.
It's some dirt weed.
Dirt shit, okay? It is brown dirt weed. That is some mids right there. Did I say mild? That's some mids.
That's some mild sauce.
Did you have any spicy food like the day before?
It was chili verde. Oh. This is the green sauce. Oh. This shit. No, I didn't have any bad food. No, I'm drinking a lot of beer and eating my normal diet, which is a lot of cheese. I was so excited to tell this story.
Like, we can.
My tits are dripping.
I'm going to end up with fucking spots. Okay. So I scratch my ass, sniff.
Ooh.
Crystal goes, everything all right?
Can somebody put that into a song? Like, where's little Dicky, bro? He's like, I get home.
I can't tell what's tears and what's sweat. But no, you're right.
Scratch my ass, sniff. Ooh. That isn't what I thought would be in my pouch.
I'm just gonna.
Okay. So. I'm fucking. Scratch and sniff. No, it's bad times. Crystal goes, is everything okay? And I go, no, I'm a little more wet than I should be. I think I shit myself. So I go to the. Actually, before I even go to the bathroom, I give it about 5-10 minutes before I even do that.
Wait, why?
Because I'm like, I think you I'm just sweaty and fat.
You know that you you smelled it. You know that you have shit yourself. That there's shit in your underwear, and you're like, nah, let me make sure that it's not shit though. Like. Let me bask in my own fucking shit ass.
I just
for 5 more minutes.
I didn't feel myself.
Just to make sure that it is actually shit up in my ass crack. I need definitive proof that that is shit that's in my ass crack.
Well, look, normally there's like
I'm gonna go take a walk around my apartment complex. When I get back, if my ass cheeks hurt, then I know that there's ass. That there's shit up in there.
Let me finish.
Right now, I don't know. I just smelled it, and it smelled like shit. But you know what? I am not 100% convinced that that's shit. It smells like it, but I ain't seen it, okay? And I haven't felt it, so I don't think it's true.
No, you're right,
I got one of the three things, okay? Until I got two of the three things, I'm just gonna sit here and bask in that shit because I'm a dirty motherfucker.
No, dude, this is a mystery. Let me explain
a mystery? No. You smelled your...
Stop. Let me explain how this is Scooby Poo.
See?
So, we got a mystery to solve. And I didn't fart. I didn't fart. There was no fucking...
But you smelled your leg.
There was no questionable, like, oh, this might be bad, and then I shit myself. It was like, I just suddenly have shit in my ass? How did that happen? So, I give
it
about...
It must be some ghost poo.
So, I go to make the kids food without washing my hands. Give it about 5-10 minutes, and then I double check. I go back for a second scratch, and I go, ooh, that's really wet.
No, I've you sweat even more, and now you spread the shit even more.
I've gotten up and walked around, helping my wife bring in groceries and shit.
Oh my god, you were disgusting.
So my wife is telling me about her day, and I stop her mid-sentence of her like complaining about some coworker shit. And I go, hold on. She goes, everything okay? And I go, I gotta go wipe real quick. And I say it in a way where I'm like, I'm still trying to portray to her. I'm trying to make her think that I might not have shit myself yet. Like, I don't want her to think that it's a done deal. So I'm like, I think I gotta go wipe. So I go sit down, and I pull a full-on just mud nug out of my fucking asshole on the toilet.
And when I pulled my How did you not feel that either?
When I pulled my boxers down, it was just fucking... They used to be blue.
Are they brown now?
Aren't they like an orangey brown?
Get him a trash can. Good. Was there blood in your shit or what?
No. I just typically I shit like a clay color.
He said he eats a lot of cheese.
It comes out Tex-Mex. You know that scene from Ghost where they're making the pottery together? It's that color. Oh, for the old heads. Anyway, so yeah, I totally had shit myself and threw those away. These are the pants I was wearing, though.
Well, anyway, we're gonna go ahead and take a break, and we'll be back.
Welcome back, everybody. You're listening to 107.2 Smooth Jazz. Today, we've got a fine selection for you that everybody is gonna love, alright? Grab your loved ones, grab your wine, sit on the couch, sit back, and relax to some classic smooth jazz.
This feels right. This feels good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're getting good at this shit, man.
Uh-huh.
We're getting good at this. Give me a fucking high five, dude. We fucking deserve it.
That was cool as shit.
Speaking of shit.
Coming back in from a shit story with some smooth jazz.
And speaking of shit.
Speaking of smooth.
My wife wanted to take a break because she was ready to go to bed. So she is gone now. But
it's about break time anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So not we left on a shit story, so we're going to start on my shit story.
It's a great story about shit, not a shit story, but it is a shit story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So mine was, I was sick, and I was standing in my living room, like, behind the curtains, you know, people can't see that, but I was standing by, and, like, in the middle of the-
Nothing exists past that.
And I was holding-
fucking ghosts over there.
Yeah. I was holding Amelia, and my wife was, like, talking to me, and I thought that I had to fart. And so I, like, went to go fart and then felt everything just, like, run down my leg, dude. Like, all the way, like, down my leg and, like, hit my calf.
Oh, fuck.
And I just, like, clenched, stopped and clenched,
trying to hold any of it that's left.
Set the baby down and was like, I gotta go. And immediately went upstairs. My wife is like, are you okay? I was like, I just shit myself. Like, I was not ashamed about it or nothing. I was like, I just shit myself. I need to go.
I wasn't ashamed when I did it.
I wasn't saying that you were. Okay.
No, that seemed like...
I'm sorry. I'm sorry if I made it seem that way. I was just saying, like, I was not, like... Yeah. I was not hiding it or nothing. I was just like, I wasn't trying to hide it. You hit it. You hit that shit. You smelled it.
I wasn't sure that I was the one who had dealt it.
My thing is that, like, you weren't sure, but still didn't go and check in that moment of you not being sure.
Well, so the thing is...
That should have been the first thing you should have done.
Used to being bigger, so I just... I'm more sweaty and wet in general.
I feel like you're acting like you're like 300 pounds.
No, but my body, when I put on weight, I just sweat more. So I've just gotten used to being fucking swampy and like having to deal with that. So when I am swampy, it's like, well, my boxers are just wet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then when you smell it.
Well, I was like, I've been at work all day and I hadn't remembered like a questionable fart. Like when I was telling you about it in the text chat, it was like, I haven't farted since like 11 a.m.
I was like, well, you have been sitting in that shit all fucking day, dude. Yeah.
Well, at least you got yours immediately cleaned up. That's good.
Well, because I immediately felt it go down my leg. There was no question about it. Because it was like the runs, too. So it was like, I knew that I had shit myself. So,
well, if it's water and it goes down your leg, you got to fix it. But mine was just hanging out.
So here's the story, though.
Okay.
Beyond that.
Yeah.
So I go upstairs and, like, take my pants and my underwear off, right?
As one does.
And clean myself up, you know, as one does, and put on new clothes. Well, my wife was leaving at the time, like, was about to leave and go somewhere. So I just kind of left it there on the floor and then went about my day. And then my wife gets home and she goes, so did you pick up your pants? And I go,
asking a question she already knows the answer to.
I go, oh shit, no. And she was like, I was like, I'll go throw them in the washer right now. And she was like, what? She was like, you don't throw shit clothes into the washer. I was like, well, then what the fuck is the washer for? Is it not going to clean my shit?
Well, when it gets the shit off with the water, it's just going to rotate the pants around in shitty water. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of soap in there, too, but there's also some shit in there.
So that's the same thing with, like, your dishwasher, where, like if somebody you should not put any dishes in there that have any sort of debris on the dishes, because then it's just going to, like... It's just going to sit, and it's going to spread it all around it, all the rest of your dishes.
Yeah.
That's basically what you're saying.
Yeah, or like the reverse situation where like if let's say your wife ran a bath and then when she was done, she got out and then you just added more soap to it and got in. That's not clean water that you're taking a bath in now. You're now taking a bath in your wife's stuff.
Moral of the story is I just threw both the pants and the underwear away. That was that.
I mean, that's the adult thing to do. That's how an adult handles
like sweatpants too that I didn't really give a shit about anyways. Man. And like, I got a bunch of pairs of underwear, so I didn't give a shit about that either. And I was just like, well, bye bye.
The last time I shit my pants that I remember, I was at my dad and stepmom's house, and she gave me a pair of her sweatpants to wear home.
Mm. I can't remember the last time I shit myself.
Was that shit or did Ollie piss on me? It was one of those.
Pissing myself. I can't remember the last time I did that too, but I'm sure it was somewhat recently.
Yeah.
Because there's been a bunch of times. Well, like I've said, you know, I grew up until I was like 13 years old fucking pissing the bed, so.
That's something I can relate to because I have an incredibly overactive bladder, and there'll be times where I'm trying to hold it at work and a little squirt comes out and I'm like, fuck.
Now you got to sit in your piss pants for the rest of the day.
Which, as you know, I'm used to just being fucking mildly, or not even mildly, like... overly moist at all times.
You're disgusting.
Like, if you were to just, like, run your fingers along my ball sack right now, it would slosh, and there'd be a wave going across the surface of my sack. You'd hear, as you did it. Yeah.
You've turned me off.
Good.
I guess. Sure.
I'm exaggerating a little. I take care of myself.
No, that turned me off, definitely.
Well, Now I want you to want me. Now I'm somehow no. like, I need you to need me.
I'm definitely like, no. No. I'm not touching you unless you have just freshly gotten out of the shower. And I've watched you take a shower.
I don't give a fuck.
I mean, fair enough. Fair enough. Fair enough. Fair enough.
Fair enough.
Fair enough. So can you do that thing over there for me?
Can I hand you the thing?
That thing over there?
Now that we've told all of our shit stories, we're on to our final segment of the podcast. We do this almost every time. You guys know it and love it as much as we do. What is... Jesus Christ.
Questions about me.
Yeah.
So, 2,000 questions about me. Oh, fuck me, dude.
Is Reaper not
I gotta wait for OBS. Hold on. Hold on.
Nothing happened.
You guys didn't miss a thing.
Yo, this episode, despite the technical difficulties, has been a banger.
Oh my god. 2,000 questions about me. Question 1,035. Do you prefer to live in the heart of the city or out in the peaceful countryside?
Peaceful countryside.
Peaceful countryside, yes, sir.
We explained why.
What do you think is the scariest thing about becoming a parent? Not them not dying.
Yeah, you just, you're or responsible.
Them dying is the scariest part.
You're responsible? Yeah, the scariest part is them not dying.
They're still alive, and you're like, fuck, are you going to die today?
You wake up every day, and they're still alive, and you're like,
fuck, god damn it, kill yourself already.
I thought you guys were accident prone. Will you just bump your head to death already?
Your kid goes like to fall off the couch, and you like have that moment where you're like, eh, "No, I'm gonna save you. I'm gonna save you. Nah, you know, I want you to live."
I can cry one more time, and I'll let you fall next time.
Oh my god,
you missed our real answers. That's our fault. But we're putting. And apparently it's your fault. Fuck you.
I'm drinking. Let me make sure Reaper's right. Okay, it is. We're good. It's recording our audio. We'll figure it out.
This is the best thing that we do.
I mean, yeah.
Of all the things, I mean.
Yeah. I'm fucking up. If you could try out a job for a day just to see if you like it, what job would you choose?
I've always wanted to be an architect.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't think I'd enjoy that.
I don't think so either.
Yeah. So, real answer, stuntman.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Mine was going to be skydive instructor.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck yeah.
Because either that first day we're going to make it or we don't.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's either my problem or it's not.
Yeah.
Either it's not a problem or it's not.
Could you imagine, like, wife swap, but, like, sky, like, extreme job swap where like
you know that skydiving doesn't require a parachute but skydiving twice does.
wait. People have done that though, right? Or am I crazy where they've done unassisted skydives and survived it?
Travis Pastrana
jumped
out of an airplane without a parachute but like had other people like He pushed his parachute out of the plane and then jumped out after it.
Yeah.
And then went and got it and put it on himself and then
I think I've seen one where they like landed on a pile of boxes and or some shit. Like they had like a runway of boxes and came in at an angle or some shit.
I think so, yeah.
I'm pretty sure I've seen some wild shit where somebody was just they had like, a wing I'm doing
suit.
It.
They had a wingsuit though, I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I feel like I know what you're talking about.
Still though.
It's without the wingsuit, it's hard to like do it at that much of an angle.
Yeah.
But with the wingsuit, you can definitely control. So I feel like I know what you're talking about.
I'm sure some crazy asshole's done it.
That or professional race car driver. regardless of what it is.
I almost said that too. Mm-hmm. But I was like, stuntman's more like you can do the car shit and the jumping off building stuff. And yeah, really, I just want to land.
I'm scared of heights, so like doing all that shit. In a car, I would probably be okay.
Yeah.
Because I know that there's a bunch of safety features, but when you're just doing, like, your own stunts, like, with, like, you falling off of a building, and then you kind of have to fall a certain way to make sure that, like, it looks good and then that you're also being safe, like, that's where I would not be okay with the heights thing. I couldn't be a stuntman
I think it was
in
a
that sense.
Fear Factor stunt, but did you see the one where they had, like, a car hanging from a crane, like, over a,
yes.
over a canyon?
Yes.
And they had to climb out and, like... get mm-hmm. something from the windshield and climb, like, the keys and yeah. start the climb back in and start the car.
Yep.
I know, like, hanging at an angle.
I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck all that.
I would do that, though. That,
I mean,
that seems awesome.
In that sense of, like, trying to win money and everything else, I could probably do it, but just know that, like,
yeah.
I'm like this as I'm trying to grab the keys.
Yeah.
What one thing could you do a little better every day? Fuck you, Book.
Book's trying to make me feel bad about myself. I'm not. I don't need this. I could drink less.
I think we all knew that was coming. People just listening to audio only were like, he's about to crack another beer.
My wife doesn't watch. What's she going to do?
She's like, I just know.
I'm half an hour away.
Who cares?
Try me, bitch.
Probably be less mean to my wife. That would probably be something I could do.
Try me, bitch.
Nope.
Have you ever hit rock bottom? Yes.
Yeah, we both have.
Yep.
Yeah.
Both been there.
I don't want to hit any lower than what I call my rock bottom.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Seriously. Yeah.
If I have a rock bottom that's lower than that, then I don't want to know about it.
I'll be dead.
Yeah.
Honestly. That would be my rock bottom below my rock bottom is dead. For sure.
That's most people's.
Yeah.
That's why it's rock bottom, and then
yeah.
you're dead. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you're underground.
Who is your biggest supporter?
My dad or my brother.
Yeah?
One of the two. It's between the both. Because my dad's definitely done more for me, but that's just because my little brother is my little brother. And it's one of those things where, like, I'm the older brother. But my little brother's always looked up to me in a way that I've, like, never understood. Where, like, my grandma will constantly tell me, or he'll just text me out of nowhere, and, like, I've always looked up to you, and I'm like, why? Like... So that's always made me feel good to have that in my life, and from either end, my dad, and my little brother.
Oh yeah,
no,
I don't know on this one. I really don't.
People believe in you.
I guess my answer would be my wife.
Yeah,
because she has kind of made me like into the respectable person that I am today. And everything kind of before that, like, there was no one person that was like, yeah, you should keep doing what you're doing.
Yeah.
You know, like, until I met my wife and then, like, kind of started changing my life around and everything. So, like, I didn't really have a lot of support in that sense of, like, hey, you're making good decisions. Like,
you weren't doing things worth supporting at the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, when it comes to, like, like, being me and somebody that's, like, always supported, like, me, it'd be you.
Yeah.
Like, 100%. Like, since the day I met you, you've always been on my side. And, I mean, you've called me out on shit. You've always made, you know, your point. But you've always been, you know, had my back and anything and always supported me. So, like, yeah.
Hell yeah.
You were my wife. Depending on which way you're looking at it.
Right.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah.
It's good that we both got a couple people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. If a reality TV show were based around your life, what would it be called?
Scooby-Poo.
Yep. Sounds about right.
Or Geek Squad? I don't know. Something about me being a nerd. What's your show, dude? What's the Austin sitcom? It'd probably just be called Austin with an exclamation point. Like your billboard or any of that shit. Just fucking Austin.
The life of Austin.
Yeah.
The life of Austin.
There you go.
Yep.
Yeah, that works. It fits you. It's nondescript enough though. People would be like, the fuck is this? Check it out.
Hold on.
Would you guys watch that?
Would you guys?
Are you a hat person? Huh. Are you a hat person, Wes?
I rarely go without the hat.
Really?
Yeah.
Literally, the other day we were on Discord. What was that, last night?
Yeah.
Yeah, last night we were on Discord.
That was last night.
I was like, dude, you look different. You were like, yeah, I'm not wearing a hat. And I was like, whoa, yeah, I can see your forehead.
Yeah, I posted my first ever selfie without a hat, and it's basically, like, so saturated and contrasted out that you almost can't even tell that I have long hair. Yeah.
Yeah. When I was younger, yes, I used to wear a beanie all the time like you. Mm-hmm. And then as I got older, I'm definitely not, like, a flat build, like, baseball cap person either.
No,
like,
they don't look good on me.
No, neither. Like, cause I got a small head.
Yeah.
So there's like so much of a gap on the side of like that you can tell that I have a small head, and I just fucking hate it, dude. I can't do it. I might like if I'm like gonna wear like a baseball cap, I'm gonna wear a baseball cap and like bend the rim of it, you know, and like do it that way.
But yeah.
That's the only time I'll like wear a hat. I wear a beanie in the winter when it's cold, but that's about it. Not anymore. So. Depends on the weather. If I'm a hat person,
yeah. I was trying to think of like a two finger gap joke, but I'll let it go.
Okay. What kind of fucking question is this?
Half these questions are bunk, dude. Your wife picked out this page, and some of these questions have been
great.
I'm gonna
fucking beat her.
I mean, every page has a couple questions where you're like, what?
Yeah, yeah. True. True.
It almost makes you mad when you read them.
Do you like your age? What?
Don't ask anybody in their 20s that.
What?
Because either my answer's not going to matter, or I don't care. Like,
do I like my age? I guess.
In the first quarter of my life, like, I don't give a fuck.
I guess.
Like, yeah.
Sure.
I liked being younger better.
At least I made it here.
Yeah.
Like, that's where I'm at. I'm like, at least I made it to 24, almost 25. Like,
even if you ask like a 60-year-old, they're going to be like, sure, but, like, everybody's going to have, like, a fucking caveat to that question.
Fuck that question. We're going to move on. We're moving on.
And whoever came up with that one, fucking shoot yourself in the fucking dick.
I feel like there was that one person that, like they had, like, 6 or 7 people that were creating questions. And every single one of those questions that is like that we've had in recent episodes
is all the same fucking person.
It's all the same guy.
And he just didn't fucking put any effort in at all.
And they're like, what the fuck kind of questions are these? But like,
it's the final day and they got to print it. So they're just like, fuck it. I just throw it on the presses.
Yeah, here we go. What particular field of study were you really interested in but decided not to pursue?
You go first.
Sadly, audio engineering.
Yeah.
I really wish I would have pursued that more, but I did not, and I regret it. But I will get there at some point.
I was going to say, we have an opportunity, based on what we're doing as our side gig, to dive into that. Like, I've learned more about doing this shit, and we have so much more to learn as we expand, so.
That's why I told you that you should go to that school. I think it's like you can do a 5-week or a 7-week program. And, like, you can go home on the weekends. Or, like, yeah, well, I think you can go home every day. I don't know if you have to live on campus, but it's in Chillicothe.
Yeah.
But, like, just go do that for fucking 5 weeks, man. And then you'll know more about this than I would.
Yeah.
Without going to that school. So, And then their advanced program is 7 weeks. So you could go and do that and then know even more. And they teach you everything from TV and movies to radio to recording and producing and all that other shit, man. Like, yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like we should both do it, really.
Yeah, we should. Yeah. I mean, it would definitely help round out the whole thing, just having that experience.
Yeah. But what about you? What was something that...
Software programmer.
Really?
Like, I know a couple coding languages, and it's been long enough that they're broken languages that I speak, kind of. Like, I'm not fluent in Python like I used to be, or JavaScript, or any of that shit.
Yeah.
But I did pursue it for a little bit, and even for a while, I was in an online college that was running me through some of those courses, and I was going to get, like, Cisco certified so I could network administrate and all that shit.
Oh, yeah.
Just the way life worked out, never really did it. Just didn't have the time. And I could still go do it. It's one of those things that, like, I still have enough interest in that eventually I'll get there.
Yeah.
And that's another thing that'll help with the podcast when it comes to, like, hosting our stuff. Like, eventually I want to have a server where, like, everything's just us and
right.
not hosted by somebody else.
Yeah.
So look forward to that, motherfuckers.
Eventually.
Uh-huh.
Eventually!
Mm-hmm.
What industry do you Hoopla. Think is most harmful to the planet or environment?
What industry do I think is most harmful?
Yeah.
Well, that's a tough question, because here's what I'll say about this. I'm going to get up on my soapbox a little bit for a second, but constantly the issue that is pushed down our throats when it comes to the global warming or climate change is that, like, on an individual level, we need to do something to stop it.
Fuck off.
That's absolute bullshit, and yes, you can on an individual level if it makes you feel better, do some things. But what's really happening is that corporations are taking advantage of the loopholes that they've lobbied for by paying tons of money to senators and politicians so that they're able to backtrack through these laws and find ways to pollute the environment without regulation. And that is what's causing a major majority of the carbon output into our atmosphere. From farming and agriculture to fucking Coke and Pepsi. Like, it doesn't matter who it is. They're fucking us and then telling us that it's us that needs to fix it.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's my answer on that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go with food.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Agriculture and food production is probably the biggest one. That's a smart bet.
Think about your local Walmart.
Yeah.
And how much food is in your local Walmart, and how much food sits on that shelf, and then when it expires, it just gets thrown away. And now think about that around our entire country.
Yeah.
Then think about that on a global scale.
How many Walmarts do you think are in Ohio alone? We can figure it out. This is something we can Google.
Hey, Siri. How many Walmarts are in Ohio?
Okay, I found this on the web for how many Walmarts are in Ohio.
Walmarts?
Sorry, I've got the, like, Australian...
Walmarts?
Australian Siri.
I'm going to start saying Walmarts from now on.
Walmarts?
Walmarts.
The Walmarts.
We're heading down to Walmart.
This is a guide, but I don't think it tells me.
There's easily over 100, right? Like, in the state. Oh, fuck, dude. That looks like the coronavirus pandemic, but Walmarts.
I would say there's probably like...
maybe like 75 to 100.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's just in Ohio.
I want to count them. One,
all right, don't get all fucking Aussie on us.
Two,
fucking, you don't have
three,
to count them.
Four.
Austin's got a beautiful
five,
mind.
Six.
I used to count ceiling tiles.
Seven.
So calm me down.
Eight. Nine. I'll get there. Just hold on, just wait.
Is the bit paying off?
No.
All right, write us in the comments. What if we got like 50 comments right now? No, stop the bit.
Stop doing the podcast altogether.
We're not even live. How do you know what's happening?
What do you like on your toast or biscuit?
I've come around to the avocado toast lately, even though it's kind of expensive. I absolutely love avocado to begin with, and there's great ways to do, like, a sea salt or, like, garlic and onion. Like, if you make it almost a guacamole, but don't go the full way.
I don't like avocado or guacamole.
I know you wouldn't.
Like that.
It's the texture, right? Like, it's mushy and weird?
No, it's the taste.
Oh, well, then the problem's with you.
I guess, yeah. It usually is. Let's be real here.
I'm not helping that people think I'm too left or liberal by saying that I like avocado toast.
But they will.
Yeah.
but they will.
Connor's going to have a heyday with that.
Oh, dude. Uh-huh. Connor's going to come after you, bro. Can't wait for the Discord to be going off.
You fucking avocado-eating fucking communist.
Yeah, yeah. All day, dude. He's going to come after you like butter on toast.
It's so weird that a right wing... Never mind.
Anyways, for me, I really like cinnamon sugar butter toast.
Oh, yeah. I used to make that all the time as a kid.
Me too, bro. It's probably why I'm going to get diabetes.
Yeah.
When I get older, it's from all the sugar and...
You're just a child when it comes to food, I'm realizing. Is that you like sweet things, you like what you like, and you've always liked
but
that.
But here's the thing, though. I do like sweet things, but I don't eat sweet things all the time.
Yeah.
Like, literally, my wife will buy me... She bought me Swiss cake rolls, and for my, like, dessert for my dinner on Wednesday... I ate them today.
Oh, okay.
So, like there'll be so many times where, like, I'll buy, like, a candy bar or something and, like, stick it in the freezer and then, like, not eat it for, like, a week or something like that to the point where my wife asked me if she can have it.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, no, I'm like, I'll eat it at some point. And she's like, well, you haven't eaten it by now, so, like...
Yeah.
And then I'm just like, fuck it, whatever, you can have it. She gets mad at me because she'll buy shit for me and then I won't eat it in that moment. And then I'm like, I'll save it for like fucking weeks. Never touch it.
It's good that you're a glutton about it, given like how, I mean, you're not super picky. Like, I've met pickier people, but given like your
I'm
typical.
I'm still kind
of
picky though.
Yeah, but given like your mood towards a lot of foods, like, it's surprising to me that you're not just like, I'm going to glutton on sweets because that's what I like. You're able to like delayed gratification with that shit.
Yeah, it just doesn't interest me.
Yeah,
like most of the time, like even
you're just not huge into food is what it is, except for the stuff that you actually like.
Yeah, I wouldn't say that. It's literally like I wish I was more into food.
Yeah,
I wish I liked more things, like beans, for instance, which comes in fucking everything nowadays. Like. It's ridiculous.
You like some beans with your sweet tea?
Seriously. Like, I feel like at some point that's going
to
happen.
That was a joke that me and my stepmom used to have when I was younger.
Really?
Which, I don't know how that started. I think she just, that maybe it was an in-joke she had with her friends, and then she told me. But she would joke around about, like, ordering, like, beans instead of ice cubes at Taco Bell. Shout out Carrie.
Fuck that. Or, like, beans and peas.
Yeah.
Because if you ever go to, like a lot of Mexican restaurants, like authentic Mexican restaurants, they have what would be called Mexican rice.
Yeah.
Which has carrots and peas in their rice. And I don't like peas. So, like, every time we go to, like, a different, like, a Mexican restaurant that I haven't been to before, I have to ask, like, hey, do peas come in your, you know, rice? Or, like... Even at La Fangada, when I get the California burrito, I have to tell them no beans. Yeah. And then there's still, like, kidney beans that comes in it because it's in the salsa or something like that. And I'm like, I just have to deal with it. Yeah. Like, I just eat it quick enough that hopefully I don't see one. If I see one, I'll pick it out. If not, then I just try and eat quick enough to where I don't taste it or anything. And it sucks. It does.
Yeah.
Like, it's, I don't want that either. I don't want to be that picky when it comes to my food. Like, I wish... Because, like, I watch a lot of, like, people who, like, travel around and try a bunch of different types of food and shit. And I'm like, I wish I could do that, but I just don't like food that much. And it is depressing.
Have you ever tried, like, a black bean veggie burger? Like, you'd probably hate that, but, like, it'd be...
Yes, and no.
Yeah.
Are you, like, here's a nice little reference for you. Max and Irma's.
Yeah.
Yeah, their black bean burger.
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Mm-hmm.
Nope,
it's
I tried.
It's unfortunate.
Yeah, it really is. Like, don't get me wrong. Like that's one of the things where people are like when I tell people this, and they're like, "Oh man, that sucks for you." And I'm like, "Yeah, I know. Like, it really does fucking suck for me. Like, it really hinders my food choices with a lot of things because I also don't want to be that super picky person that's like, "Hey, can I get this with no beans, no sour cream?" You know, yeah, no peas, and, like, make it super specific. I just like to be able to be like, I want the California burrito, and then you bring me a California burrito.
Yeah,
and
the way it comes.
The way that it comes.
Yeah.
Because I've been a cook, too. I've worked in a restaurant, so I know how it is when you get something and it's like, there's five different things.
And, dumb bitch.
And you're like, literally all you want is just steak in a shell. That's yeah. it. And rice. Like, you could have just been like, steak, rice, shell. And yeah. that would have been easier than the five things where you were like, no beans, no rice, no sour cream. Like, yeah. I don't want to be that person, but I am. And it sucks. Yeah. It does. And it's caused issues with my younger life, too, where like, my godmother was my babysitter for a while, and she made me, like, force-fed me vegetable soup. So, like, tomato soup, but had, like, peas and carrots and maybe some other stuff in there.
Yeah.
And she's, like, forcing me to eat it, and I'm literally gagging as she's, like, forcing it into my mouth.
And potatoes and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. And she's getting mad at me because I'm, like, gagging and, like, about to throw up. And I'm pretty sure I went into the bathroom and threw up. But just from the constant gagging and everything else. And I'm, like, I'm sorry, too. Like, I'm... She thinks I'm, like, lying about it and that I just, like, don't want to eat it. And I'm, like, I would eat it if I liked it.
Yeah.
It's not like I'm trying to tell you or trying to be disobedient here or that I'm not hungry, because guess who didn't fucking eat lunch that day?
Right.
This guy.
It's one of those...
Because I didn't eat what she fucking made.
Yeah.
So I went hungry the rest of the fucking day.
So you didn't have a reason to not want it, like...
Yeah. No, I was hungry. I wanted to eat, but I literally could not eat it.
Yeah. It's literally one of those things where, like, enough people think that their experience with a certain thing is, like, the max of what that is. So people have enough experience with food, and they don't like certain things. So when you tell them, like, oh, I can't eat this, they assume that it's them being like, well, I like my Starbucks order a certain way, and if I don't get it that way, then it ruins my whole day. Like,
yeah. No.
It was like when I first started having panic attacks, and my mom didn't believe me at first. And I was having a panic attack in the back of the car while she was picking up her friend from Narcotics Anonymous to go, like, to a meeting. And she's bringing me along, which was stressing me out because, like, I had just found out all this stuff. And, like, we're going to Narcotics Anonymous meetings all of a sudden. It wasn't normal for me. And I'm already, like, at a bad point in my life. So I started having panic attacks. So I'm in the back of this car and I'm having a panic attack. I'm freaking out. I can't breathe. And I keep telling her, like, I'm going to puke because I can't breathe. And, like, I'm hyperventilating. And she's like, well, you're making yourself do it. And it's like, well, no, I'm not, like... And then that was making me more upset. And then eventually I had to make them stop the car, force them. And then she's like, oh, you just worked yourself up to the point where you're puking. And it's like, no, I'm, like, this is happening. Like, what are you fucking talking about? Like...
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
You did work yourself up, but not intentionally.
Yeah.
It's not like you forced yourself to get to that point.
I wasn't actively deciding to, like, my body was reacting in a way that I couldn't control.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the word I'm looking for? Involuntary.
Yeah.
Like.
You can't have beans in your, like, you just.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was like, I think I talked about this, but one of the guys I used to work with at my old job site, I was telling him about how, like, I don't like beans. And he, like, kind of looked at me and was like, what? And I was like, I literally can't eat them. I was like, it'll make me gag. And he was like, whatever.
Yeah, he doesn't believe you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, I almost forced myself to go and fucking gag on some beans just to be like.
Hold on, let me go get some beans.
Like, seriously, dude. Like, let me fucking show you.
Yeah.
Because it was the fucking burrito that they had, the chimichangas that we would call it. And the first time that they had made them, they didn't make them with any beans. It was, like, with, like, some, like, fried peppers and shit.
Yeah.
And, like, eggs. Oh, it was fucking delicious, man. And some type of, like, sauce, man, that made it a little spicy. And some sausage, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Delicious, man. I was like, oh, man, I can't wait for next week, bro. I'm gonna smash the shit out of this. I took one bite the next week. And I remember the feeling of that bean hitting the back of my throat.
Yeah.
And then spitting and gagging that bite out, mm-hmm. and then looking down and seeing beans. And it was like, I didn't look down when I took the bite because I assumed that it was going to be the same way. So I took the bite and was just sitting there chewing, and then it was literally like me gagging and spitting it out, involuntarily doing that.
Yeah.
So like,
that's brutal, dude.
It sucks. It really does. Especially considering like a lot of the shit that mushrooms, can't do mushrooms either.
Oh, I love mushrooms.
Dude, and see, that's another thing. Like, it's like my wife loves mushrooms. She loves beans. She loves peas. And then it makes it difficult when she wants to make something, but I don't like half of the shit that she likes in her everyday food.
Yeah.
So now it's like she has to kind of make a whole different like meal basically just to deal with me. It sucks. It makes me feel like shit. It does. But I got to remember that it's not my fault and that it's just how my body is. And but it still does make me feel bad. Like, I wish I had more of a food palate than what I do.
Yeah.
It makes me afraid to go to different countries and try food. Because I'm like, what if I went and visited fucking Spain or Japan and then couldn't find any food that I like?
Yeah.
Then what?
Japan would be rough for you.
Then what the fuck am I supposed to do?
Eat a bunch of rice-based stuff.
I like rice, though.
Yeah. That's what you'd have to do in Japan.
Or ramen.
Yeah.
I could find some nice ramen places, I'm sure. I could definitely eat some ramen shit. But that's what I mean. Like, people are like, oh, I travel around, I've tried so much food. I'm like, I'm afraid to do that. Because I'm like, what if I travel to a country for a week and there ain't shit that I can find that I like, and then I starve for a week, basically?
Yeah.
Like, that'd be terrifying. I gotta go find a fucking McDonald's in India, you know, just to eat some food because I can't eat any of the local food. I don't fucking want that.
Yeah.
I want to be able to experience the world and the culture and the food and shit. Like, it's just not, it's not fair. And it sucks. It does. It really does.
I renamed my dick Beans so you could spit and gag on it.
That was actually pretty good. I'm not going to lie, that was pretty good. That was...
It took me a good 3 minutes to come up with the right wording for it.
But that was so good.
It wasn't that good.
No, that was good.
It made me laugh.
That was good. That was really good. I'm
I've been thinking about it since you said spit and gag.
I was
trying to listen to your story and also come up with the joke. I'm such an asshole.
I renamed my dick Beans so you could spit and gag on it. That's fucking that's great. That's great.
I should do stand up.
That's almost just as good as your mom joke.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm really sorry, though, that's your situation with food. Like,
don't be sorry. It's okay. I mean, it's just who I am. It's how it is, and I just have to deal with it, man.
Yeah, it could be worse, but it still sucks, you know?
I just hate it when people get mad at me for it.
Yeah, that's like, the part that sucks the most.
Or, like, people don't believe me or anything, and it's like, I wish I wasn't like this. Like, yeah. I wish that I could experience more food and more food choices and not be such a picky person, but that's just, like, how I am. My brother didn't eat fucking mashed potatoes, and I still don't think he eats mashed potatoes. I fucking love
mashed potatoes. Are delicious.
And he didn't like hamburger for the longest time either.
Yeah.
I don't know if he eats it now, but like, and we're like, how I would be about eating beans, where it's like, I'm going to choke and gag on them and then like cry because you're making me eat this food, is how he would be about mashed potatoes.
Yeah.
And then I would look at him like, what the fuck is your problem, dude? Like, I love mashed potatoes.
Yeah.
Why do you not love mashed potatoes?
That's funny. You've got a similar thing, but you're also looking
when
at him.
When I was a child.
Yeah, but still, it's like.
But true.
Yeah.
But he would like full on have a fucking, like, he would cry about it.
Yeah.
I'd be upset.
That's how.
But I wouldn't cry unless you fucking force that shit. Unless you're like what my godmother did, where she was like literally like force feeding it. Like, if you're like forcing me to eat it and you're like, you're going to sit there until you eat that, I'll sit there all fucking night, dude.
Yeah. Well, I've ran into that with my kids lately. Like, Avi's like a fucking food disposal. Like, you can just give her anything and she'll eat it. She likes almost everything.
She's like Patrick on that one episode when they're eating the Krabby Patties and he just vacuums.
Yeah.
You know?
That kid eats and she eats it all.
Oh, yeah.
But fucking Ollie, like, he really only likes fruit and vegetables. So, like, you'll be like, you want some chicken nuggets? And he's like, no, I want a banana and some green beans. And it's like, I'll make you that, but...
No shit.
Yeah. Which I guess is a good thing, but it's hard to get him to eat, like... I mean, he likes McDonald's. Like, you get him some chicken nuggets from there, obviously. All kids like trash food, but... I just
don't
make him like...
Don't McDonald's like that.
It's trash food, but if you don't just make, like, McDonald's some fucking... Like,
we could get McDonald's money someday.
My wife made, fuck it. We could. We could get some McDonald's someday. Some McDonald's money someday. We're definitely getting some McDonald's someday.
And then we'll lose it.
Yeah.
Some joke.
But yeah, anyway, that's all besides the point. I've actually kind of got to pee again, and I'm disappointed in myself.
Okay.
But I just wanted to let you know so we could decide what to do.
Just go take a fucking piss, dude.
Okay. How many more questions do we have left?
Two.
Okay. Sure. Cool.
Yeah.
We'll wrap
this. Can I try your beer?
Yeah, of course. I'll be right back.
Dogfish Head 60-minute IPA that you said that has like a cinnamon.
It's got it's not quite cinnamon, but there's a little bit of a bite to it.
There's a little bit of a bite. A little bit of tight. A little bit of a bite of cinnamon. See, I don't drink IPAs enough to be able to, like, tell the difference between IPAs. Because it just tastes like the same fucking IPA that he would bring over on any other day. Like, it's just the same shit. It just all has that, like, that IPA taste to it. And, like, I don't know. I feel like that's kind of, like, the same thing with wine. Where when you first start drinking wine, you're like, all wine tastes the same. But after you drink it for so long, then you start to notice, like, you know, the walnut flavor to it or whatever, the smoky flavor to it or, like, where it's from and everything else. But
yeah. I heard you say that tastes like every other IPA that you taste. Yeah. You just don't have the palate for it.
I don't.
It's something that you gotta work up to.
Is it an acquired...
Yeah. It's like coffee. And even when I first started liking coffee, it's still like as you get more and more into it to the point where like I use different like flasks or I use my French press or I do pour over sometimes. Like it's to the point where the different types of brewing methods I can taste the difference between even with different coffee grounds. Or using the same coffee ground, like even if it's just Walmart bought fucking pre-ground coffee and I'd brew it different ways. Like I'm at the point where I'm like, oh, that has more of a fruity note to it this way.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think that I'm that way about anything except for mac and cheese. specifically shells and cheese.
That's
like,
so
if
awesome.
You were to put like Velveeta shells and cheese in front of me, Aldi's shells and cheese in front of me, and like Kroger shells and cheese in front of me, I could tell you what each one was.
I had to tell Crystal the other day to not buy certain types of shells and cheese. I was like, it's Velveeta or maybe this other brand, but
we're buying Velveeta or just don't buy shells and cheese.
Well, that's what I was telling her. Like, it's either maybe this other store brand, but
if we're on a budget,
yeah,
and I'm really craving some shells and cheese, we'll get this off brand.
Yeah.
But any other time, spend the fucking money.
And if it comes with a powder packet?
Don't even get me fucking started on your fucking Kraft mac and cheese. It's real cheese. I don't give a shit.
Powdered cheese is not, I mean, you can say fuck it off. Came from cheese, but that's not cheese.
Fuck off.
Yeah, I'm with you on that one, bud.
It's either liquid gold or nothing. Get the fuck out of here, all right?
We're both cheesy and sleazy. I'm finding this out.
Fuck.
Fucking full of cheese, bro. Two more questions.
Would you allow your foreign exchange student to live in your house? Only if it's a woman, you get the rest.
I remember being younger and being like, wait, that's a thing that happens? And just being like, now there's like a random person who doesn't even barely speak English. I was a racist 7-year-old. But it was always like, even at my job now, we have two people that work, or one person now because of the furlough and the fucking pandemic. There's two people from Belgium who won the immigration lottery. So like other countries have programs where like, or in America as well, where like you just get picked from a pool of the population. And they're like, hey, you won this lottery. Do you want to go to this other country? And we'll pay for your way to go there. And it's like completely paid for. They set you up and then you get a job and fucking you're in another country. And it's to like increase diversity and like export culture and shit like that. Like it's the reason for it's good, but it's one of those things where you're like, I didn't even know that was a thing until I started working at my job, where it was like, well, that's cool, but also seems like, what the fuck is that?
I didn't know that was a thing until just now.
Yeah, it's wild. Immigration lotteries, like a bunch of different countries have them, and people just get randomly picked, and they can either decline or accept. So like, I've got Belgians that work at my job. The one dude, people at my job know about the podcast, but the one dude,
they haven't gotten this far.
Let's be real here.
Nobody's gotten this far.
He called a couple people who work there stupid Americans and then like had to go talk to HR about it. And it was like, you won an immigration lottery and you're talking shit. Fuck off. Get out of our country, bro. America.
Like, that's one of those things where like if you don't like it, then you can go back, bro. Yeah, like
you accepted it. I don't fuck off. Like,
yeah, no. Well, I don't know. You accepted it on different expectations, and then it wasn't what you expected, and now you're like, nah, you dumb American.
He's a big guy. He eats a couple Big Macs a day. He's living the fucking American lifestyle. Like,
he still could be smarter than us, though.
I doubt it. My job's harder than... God, people at my job, I'm so sorry. My job's so much harder than his job, though, and he can shut the fuck up.
Oh, hey, fair enough, yeah. Then.
There's a few people who I work with who are going to enjoy what I'm saying because I know they listen to the podcast. And there's a few people who are going to be upset about what I'm saying. We're going to have to avoid them for like a week.
Yeah. Hell yeah. I'm glad nobody listens to the podcast that I know. So that's great. Have your parents ever told you something as an adult they kept from you as a child?
All right. So... we'll save my answer for another episode because I do have a story for this that I can't tell right now. Doing it right now isn't gonna do it because I'm 3 beers in. I've already been high and unhigh. I'm tired now. Like, I don't have the emotional energy to actually go into the story.
Wow.
So I want to hear your answer. Really? And I'm going to make a note to myself that I will tell this next time somewhere at the beginning or middle of a podcast because I can't do it right now.
Okay.
But I'll make a note.
That's fair.
But yeah, that's what's something they told you?
I had to ask about it, and it was like the first time that my mom had done crack and where and when it was and like how it happened and everything else. But I had to like ask about that as like an adult, you know, because I had questions after all that shit had happened and I'm getting older. I'm like, okay, well then how the fuck did this shit happen to you? Like what led up to everything? Like, were you being badgered about it? Like, did they constantly ask you to do it? And you were like, no. And then finally one day after having a whole bunch of stress and everything else, you just like snapped type of shit, which was kind of the situation. And then, yeah. Which helped me out in the sense of where I was like, don't agree to peer pressure, basically. Where it was like, you know that shit's bad. You've seen what it does to your mom and to your own family. So like, just don't do it.
Yeah.
Bam. And there you go. And that was I guess kind of the answer that I was looking for in there, but there's been some other things that me asking about my childhood and being like, "Hey, so I remember when this happened." And they were like, "Oh, you remember that?" I'm like, Yeah.
Yeah.
I fucking remember that.
How did you think I'd forget?
Like, thank you. Yeah. Like, you're definitely part of the reason that my life has been fucked up for a long time.
Yeah.
Let's be real here. And I love both of my parents. And not to kind of point the blame in one area, but my mom has definitely made some decisions and things in her life that has definitely impeded my life. And my dad has kind of always been there for me. Not that my dad is also a perfect person, because my parents have never been together. They were divorced like shortly after I was born. Like, and I've heard that my dad did some shit. I've heard that my mom have done some shit. So like, neither one of them are the best person. But again, y'all are also the reason why my childhood was not bad, but it was also fucked up. And I still deal with that shit today.
Yeah.
Every day. And I remember a lot of shit that if I were to bring that shit up now, it could probably still cause problems.
Yeah.
Where the other person would be like, not that they're even together anymore, but they would still be like, hey, so just finding this out, really? Mm-hmm. Like, yeah. Type shit, you know? And then that would be the thing.
That's the problem with asking tough questions. Like, because there's consequences to the answers, depending on who hears them. And that's why I'm going to have trouble going into my answer. But yeah, a lot of the same things. Like, my parents divorced. Well, they weren't even married when they had me. They separated at a very young age when I was still very young. I think it was almost two when they separated for real. And then, like, I grew up thinking my stepdad was my real dad. And when my mom passed, he came to the funeral. And afterwards, I had a bunch of questions for a bunch of people in the family. And he was the first person that I went to, because he was there for, like, the shit that happened after my dad when I was real young. So I sat down at dinner with him and asked him a bunch of questions. It was like, just one of those things where, like, it would have helped to have known what was going on when I was littler, but I wouldn't have understood. So, like, finding out now
helps you understand it.
But it also hurts in a very real way, because you can put together the pieces of, like, that's why this went the way it did, or exactly, that's why I felt the way I did.
Yeah.
So you almost relive it, but with the extra added information, which makes it hurt almost a little bit more.
That's like, should you lie to your kids, or should you just tell them the truth from the get-go?
Yeah.
You know, like, me personally, after being what I've been through and everything else, just tell them from the get-go. Like, just tell me what the fuck's going on. I'm for sure will not understand it as a child, but I'll understand it when I get older more, and I'll also not have resentment towards you as a parent for not lying to me and then telling me the truth later.
Yeah.
Because you do the same shit with me as a child, where, like, I break something and then you're like, oh, how did that get broken? And I'm like, oh, I don't know. I don't know how they got broken. Like, such and such must have happened. And then later on I go, oh no, like, we were throwing the ball in the house. And you were like, well, you should have just told me from the get. Well, you should have just fucking told me from the get-go.
Yeah.
Don't fucking keep me in the dark about this shit, because I'm just not going to understand it. I get it. You're a child. You're not going to understand it. But when I get older, at least you fucking told me what it was.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. I'm so sorry.
Listen, if that was anybody else, I would be so mad right now.
Oh my God.
But
I literally coughed right as I was taking a sip.
I see drops over there too. Oh, like,
fuck, dude. That
was on the book, man.
It's all over my shit.
You fucked up.
Yeah, because I meant to do that. Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's all right. It's quite all right, mate.
Fuck. Okay. We all cleaned up?
Fuck you!
Okay, well, COVID everywhere.
Yeah, we're basically.
Spreading it around.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
I just have fucking allergies, man.
No, that's legit. Like, it's everywhere.
That's what she said. What was I talking about? Where was I at before you so rudely interrupted me?
Oh.
We were talking about the hurt of finding out things afterwards.
Oh, yeah, and, like, just telling me the truth from the get-go. I'm not gonna understand it when I'm younger, but, like, when I get older, at least I'm gonna appreciate the fact that you didn't fucking lie to me. And that the understanding will come with age, and then it'll be easier for me to understand when I get older, and as I get older, than when you lie to me, and then I get to a certain point.
Yeah.
And then I'm, like, reliving everything like you said all over again. It's over my microphone and everything.
I'm just like noticing more things as
I'm done. I don't care anymore.
What I will say is that the thing that hurt me the most, I'll just come out with it. Fuck it. Why wait? The thing that hurt me the most finding out as an adult was that my mom padded and basically lied about the way things went down between her and my dad on multiple occasions at multiple different ages, and she had multiple chances to just be upfront with me about what had actually happened. And the way I had finally found out was that my stepmom and my dad had taken me to Zumbezi Bay, or maybe back when it was still like Wyandotte. No, it was Zumbezi Bay.
So they take you to a fun ass place and they're like, hey.
Well, so I'm like, I'm almost 17, I want to say. Or maybe I'm 17, almost 18.
Yeah.
And they're finally like, well, you're almost an adult, so we'll just, like, kind of... Carrie, my stepmom, had just been, like, dwelling on it ever since she started dating my dad and knew what had happened and watched him go through it and all the pain he went through dealing with my fucking mom. And, like, she was one of the sweetest people you'll ever meet, but also one of the most, like, narcissistic and, like, self-absorbed, like, just greedy because of her issues. Like,
yeah,
a lot of the things that, like, made her caring and supportive was that she could use that you thought she was caring and supportive as a way to manipulate you, which had its good and its bads, obviously. Like, she was a complicated person. So my stepmom, while we're, like, sitting down at the food court at Zumbezi Bay, finally, like, explains everything she watched my dad go through dealing with my mom in the period where, like, they were separating, and then the years where my dad was constantly calling her, like, I want to be a part of my son's life. And my mom's like, no, and fighting him in court, and, like, being a total douchebag and trying to get as much money as she possibly can out of him, because it benefits her.
Yeah.
But she was using me as, like, a chess piece against my father. And all the while, I didn't know that I actually had a dad till I was 11. So, like, there was multiple times where she'd be talking to somebody on the phone in the middle of the night in a heated tone, and that was my dad. And as a kid, I had no idea. But then when I finally found out, it was, like, all these times where it was, like, she had told me that they had decided together to split up because they were so young, and that he wasn't ready to handle it, and he was going through so much shit, and she had all of her things. And she had support from my grandma, so she was able to, like, take care of me, and he could go off and deal with his shit, and then eventually come back together. But that never really happened, and the only way I got to meet my dad was because he kind of forced his way back in after fighting with her so long. So when I'm sitting down with my stepdad, who I used to think was my dad, asking him, like, what is all this shit, with in mind what my stepmom had told me, and now what my stepdad is telling me after my mom's gone, is like, well, she'd been in and out of rehab before she even had me. And I hadn't known that till I talked to Bill, my stepdad. It was one of those things where, like, oh, well, that's the piece of information nobody gave me, was that she was a drug addict before she even had me. I thought it was like she started in her mid-20s.
Right.
So when you tell me, like, that's been from before I was even conceived, she's been like this, well, then it all falls into place. And I just, somebody should have fucking, like, made me aware that there was something wrong before then. By the time my mom has passed and I'm in my mid-20s and I'm finding this out, it's like, well, I've just been wondering this shit for 10 years. Like,
Like, almost like, was I the reason?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's no way that, it's like, you so couldn't painful. Think of that, too. Yeah. The way, like, going through that, and you're like, well, am I the reason that she, like, became this person? And then you come to find out that, like, she was like this before she had you, and then you're like, well, that fucking makes sense. Yeah. Like,
it's almost comforting and also, like, the worst thing at the same time.
I still don't know the specifics about my mom and dad. Yeah. I've always heard, ask your mom and then ask your dad. Like, it's always that back and forth. I'm like, can y'all just fucking tell me what the fuck happened to y'all?
Yeah.
So I know what not to do, you know? Like, I've heard some shit about my dad, and I've obviously heard some shit about my mom. So it's like, I don't know who to believe in that situation. It's like, I just wish somebody would just tell me what the fuck really happened. Just so I just want to learn from y'all's mistakes. Like, that you're my parent, and that's kind of like, that's why I feel that you should tell your kids the truth. Yeah. And that it should just be a thing, you know? Like, that's just how it is. And thinking about it, and as you know, some of the things that I've dealt with in my life, telling my child that is going to be extremely difficult.
Yeah.
And it's not going to be fun. But I also don't want to lie to her. And I also don't want her to find it out in a bad way. Especially after I'm gone. You know? And then she can't ask me questions. And she can't find out from me, you know, what is going on. Because I know that that, you know, plays a lot into it. And
I think parents think that they're protecting their kids, but when really what they're doing is finding a roundabout way to protect themselves until they're gone, and then you can't ask them anymore. Like,
yeah. That's a tough thing to face, though. But I definitely think that you should face it as a parent, now that I'm, like, thinking about it.
Yeah.
You know? And like I said, it's not going to be something that's easy, but when the time comes, it'll definitely be a thing that I'm going to have to relay.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, being honest in the moment is going to help your kid out in the future, even if it sucks in the moment.
Yeah. And again, it's I like coming with it with a sense of, like, I want you to learn from my mistakes, you know, like, I want you to be able to have knowledge that you wouldn't necessarily be able to have without going through it, but without going through it.
Yeah.
You know, like, and that's only going to benefit you even more.
Well, it's not healthy to have heroes or look up to your parents who you think are perfect, because, like, you're eventually going to find out that they're not.
And yeah.
The longer that takes, the more, like, painful that's going to be when you finally do find out, like, oh, they're just regular people who don't really know what's going on, just like me. Like, that's... it's more shattering the later in life you find that out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure.
Is that the last one?
It was.
All right. Well, we did it.
And it was a big question.
Yeah.
It was a big question. I commend you for being able to talk about the things that we talk about. Because I can only imagine, you know?
It takes a few beers.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
Like, as you're talking about some of this shit, like, I tear up, too. But I also, like, think about it as, you know, I gotta be strong for you, man. And I know that you're a really strong person. And that you deal with this shit every day. I know. And I just commend you, man. I'm so happy that you're here. I'm happy that we can have these conversations together, because we really do, like, resonate with each other.
Yeah.
And we like, as the kids would say these days,
please tell me we got all that.
Yeah. As the kids would say these days, we vibe together, bruh.
Yeah. So, we vibing.
We vibing,
yeah,
together. And I really appreciate that.
It's a whole ass mood.
Yeah. Seriously.
I appreciate it too, man. We've both been through some shit. I think we can see and respect that in each other in a way that, like, some friends don't.
Yeah.
We're super open about that type of stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I am running out of space on my laptop, though, because I need to move some shit around. Yeah. This is the first time that that's ever happened, and we're, like, at that point where we should end it anyway. So follow us on Facebook at Blue Skies from the Basement. Follow us on Instagram at Blue Skies Podcast. Send us an email at blueskiespodcast@gmail.com with any of your questions or answers to any of the questions that we had. You can call in or text at 614-600-2056.